Praise the Lord, this is Master Prophet E. Bernard Jordan, your master teacher. Soon we'll be starting to do most of our teaching in Patreon because we're going to be moving into a time where I want to look at it as mystery school. You know, a lot of places teach the history of Jesus, but so many miss the mystery of Christ. Do you not know you can have a historical Messiah or a mystical one? I choose both. And so we've taught you about the history of Jesus being the Son of God, but are you ready for the mystery of Jesus? The mystery of the gospel. I want to look at prayer for a moment. Prayer, we have looked at and just understood it as talking to God. But I want to offer you something else that prayer probably does that you didn't know that prayer was even doing. Let's talk about prayer with you for a moment. What is prayer? Prayer is an editing tool. Prayer goes down into the subconscious and edits it. Edits the subconscious because the subconscious is what brings about the objective reality. You see, you don't get what you want. Your want is the objective mind. You get what you are. You are is your subjective mind. That is the deep part of yourself. The Bible says, be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. I thought I would leave that with you for a moment. Come join us in Mystery School. And if you're not following us, why don't you text the information that is on the screen so that you can be connected. To be connected is to be set free. Peace. I just want to ask a question right now, and the question is, what is the breaking news, Prophet Joshua?
Well, the breaking news is an attention getter, Master Prophet.
What does it sound like?
Breaking news!
Oh my God.
And you know, that will definitely get your attention.
So why do you do the breaking news? Well, I do the breaking news, Master Prophet, because there's so many different words in Hebrew for cry out, and unto the Lord. So one of the words for cry out is Shabbat, Master Prophet. And that was interesting because a Shabbat was not like a cry out, like you wanted something from God, but it was a cry out of thanksgiving, a cry out of salute and honor unto the Most High. It was as if the human voice became a shofar, Master Prophet.
Wow. And so here we do the breaking news every time you do a $1,000 seed or
breaking news.
All right.
And there it is. Why don't you produce the next sound effect? I'm waiting for your seed today.
Breaking news.
Breaking news.
To be the best that I could be. It's like every time I take one step, something's right in front of me. Lord, will I be without your grace and mercy? Now I have one question. You changed my whole life.
You made my wrongs right.
Made every wrong right. I'll never know why.
You made something out of nothing.
Wow, I'll never know. My life was headed out of control. Somehow I shifted in overload. But then you came and did a work in me. Out of everything I once was, somehow you saw a masterpiece.
You changed
my whole. You made my wrongs, right,
and for the rest of my life,
I'll never know why,
you did
like only you could. So with my head held high, my hands lifted in the air, I give you all the praise, 'cause you're the only one that could have made that made. And what you saw in me, I don't know. But Lord, I'm glad that you saw it. And every piece of me that was a mystery.
Praise the Lord. This is Master Prophet E. Bernard Jordan and
Prophetess Deborah Jordan
and Bishop Elect,
our loud mouth son.
All right, we'll do it one more time. We'll do it one more time.
No, we're gonna keep this just the way it is.
What?
Because that's who you are.
You're right.
This is who you are. Why
God
be fake?
Made you that way.
He sure did. He sure did.
Does he a fearfully wonderful man?
Well, we want to welcome you to the Power of Prophecy. You're going to get music.
Music.
What else?
Prophecy.
You're going to get breaking news.
And you're going to hear the word of the Lord that the master prophet, Dr. E. Bernard Jordan, will be teaching.
That's right. The company of prophets.
That's right.
That will be prophesied.
Listen,
and teaching.
You got about a healthy 15 seconds to go and get your water, get your Bible, get your smart devices.
Bathroom break?
It's because we're coming live.
Well, let me just say this thing. When you connect with the power of prophecy, your life will start up just like that engine.
Yes, it will.
Because guess what? You've been on pause all your life.
Come on,
and you need a restart.
You're gonna take me out.
I'll see you live right now. And remember, destiny is
not left up to chance,
but
it's a matter of choice.
Destiny is not left up to chance, but it's just a matter of choice.
This is Bishop Carlton Pearson, and you're watching The Power of Prophecy.
The master prophet is anointed. I mean, this man talked about a black president way before Barack Obama went to USC.
I was blown away by the prophecy. The prophecy hit all the marks and told me of my future.
I'm listening to this man prophesy to me. I just scream, I said, I'm done.
The Master Prophet began to hear from God. We were trying to wait and hear the rest of the word, but nothing else came. It was just
9-1-1.
Well, God gives certain people certain insight toward guiding in the flow of where God wants us at the time in history that he's put us on earth for.
Oh, you know, he's a false prophet.
We were called the money church.
The love of money is the root of all evil.
I did not go into the ministry to get rich. I got rich doing ministry.
It wasn't about taking a vow of poverty.
The lack of money is the root of all evil.
How can you even be a Christian and not preach the message of prosperity? Mary, Martha, and Lazarus, they were rich people, had big houses.
When you lack money, you lack choices.
You have money, you can do great things in ministry. Believe his prophets, and so shall ye prosper.
God bless you, and happy Sunday to everyone. We're so glad that you are here, and thank you for your patience on this special, special Sunday. It's the last Sunday of September. Where has the time gone? We're so glad that you are here in Jesus' name. You know what? We're still going to have a great time in the Lord. I want to thank you all for being here today. We thank the Lord for his goodness, his mercy, and his loving kindness towards us. Can you tell God thank you this afternoon? I know your heart is filled with gratitude for all the blessings he's done for you. If there's ever a time to be grateful, it is today. It is right now. Think of what God did just for you today. Think about last night, last week, last month, a year ago, 2 years ago, 5 years ago. God has kept you. He's preserved you. He's healed you. He's kept you alive. And guess what? Guess what? It's not by accident that you're alive today. But we thank God today you're alive because there's so much more for you to be, do, and have. So we thank the Lord for his grace this afternoon. Would you lift your hands and bless God? Will you tell him thank you for another day? Thank you for preserving my life. Yes, there's been challenges. Yes, there has been circumstances. But guess what? You're still alive, and there's more for you to do, be, and have today. And in him we live, in him we move and have our being. That's why we make a joyful noise today. I want to remind you that our loving God, the Father, loves you unconditionally. There's absolutely nothing that you can do to stop God from loving you. And for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. He continues to pour out his love today. Would you lift up your hands? Would you open up your heart and receive the love of God towards you? Receive his grace, his forgiveness, his acceptance today. There is, I'll say it again, there's absolutely nothing you can do to change God's mind concerning his people. Amen and amen. Well, we're going to get the lineup of the company of prophets. Amen. We're going to get this moving in this hour. We're so glad that you are here in Jesus' name. Today is Sunday, the 25th day of September. Amen and amen. And as always, we open this up with our leading lady, worthy class master, Deborah Jordan. Amen. Going to ask the next worthy class master, amen, to open up to say your name at this time. Amen. All right, I'm not hearing anyone. Just let me know. Amen. Next worthy class master. Just hold on. We're going to work this out in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. We're going to work this out in Jesus' name. Just hold on and bear with us. Hallelujah, hallelujah. All right, if you can hear me in the virtual campus, would you please let me know?
We can hear you, Prophet Stephen.
Amen. All right. All right, next worthy classmaster, please announce yourself. All right, then let's get the leaders of the Temple Seers.
Good afternoon, Temple Seer Nichelle Barron. God bless you, Prophet Brown, and I'll be here until 2:30 p.m.
Amen. Temple Seer Nichelle Barron is with us to 2:30 p.m. Amen. Next, Temple Seer or worthy classmaster.
Temple Seer Antoinette Harris here until 2 p.m.
Bless you, Temple C. Antoinette Harris here to 2 p.m. I'm going to follow that. My name is Prophet Stephen Brown. Amen. Number 4. And I'm going to put 5 and 6, Prophet and Elders Valina and David Bratton. Valina Bratton as number 5. Number 6, Prophet David Bratton. Number 7 is Bishop-elect Joshua Jordan. Amen and amen. All right, let's get the next, I got a habit of looking, I'm sitting in a different position, so I got a habit of looking at the other camera. Let's get the next, either worthy class master or Temple Seer.
Temple Seer, Olympia Castillo, good morning, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Temple Seer, Olympia Castillo, amen, and I know you are part of the worship experience today, amen. And you have access to come to the stage, right, at the point in time?
Yes and yes.
Amen, amen. So we're certainly glad for Prophet Olympia Castillo today, amen, who will be doing the offering, amen, along with Deacon Jennifer Mobley, amen. Mm-hmm. All right, amen. And we have Prophet Barbara Tucker, who will be doing the prayer as well. Let's go on with the next prophets. Go ahead and announce yourself at this time. Temple Seers and worthy class masters.
Yeah, Iris Green, God bless you.
God bless you, Prophet and Deacon Iris Green. You are here, amen. You are number 9.
Yes, thank you.
Next, Temple Seer.
Temple Seer Linda Green until 2:00.
Temple Seer Linda Green is with us to 2 p.m. Bless you. Next prophet, Temple Seer or worthy class master. All right, let's open up to our temple guards.
Temple guard Evelyn Lilly.
Bless you, temple guard Evelyn Lilly. Bless you. You are number 11.
Thank you.
Amen. Next temple guard.
Good morning, Prophet Stephen. This is Prophet Barbara Tucker. God bless you. Good morning.
God bless you, Prophet Barbara Tucker. Amen. I understand you're doing prayer today, and are you able to get on the screen?
Yes, I'm sitting on the stage.
Awesome, awesome. Bless you. Amen. Next, temple guard, temple seers.
Prophet Yolanda Rojas.
God bless you, Prophet Yolanda Rojas. You're number 13. Next prophet.
Prophet William Richards.
Prophet William Richards, how are you today?
Great and thankful. And you, Prophet Stephen?
Bless you. God bless you, man of God. You are number 14. Next prophet.
Prophet Pat Green.
God bless you. Number 15 is Prophet Pat Green. You are number 15. Next prophet.
Prophetess Denise Bullock, I will start at 2:00.
Prophet Denise Bullock will start at 2 p.m. and is number 16. Amen. Next prophet, temple guard, or temple seer, or worthy class master. All right, let's open up to our initiates and neophytes.
Prophet Latoya Dawkins until 4 p.m.
Prophet Latoya Dawkins is with us to 4 p.m. and is number 17. Next prophet.
Prophet Xavier Quarterman until 2 p.m.
Okay. Was that Prophet Xavier Quarterman?
Yes, Prophet, till 2 p.m.
Amen. Prophet Xavier Quarterman is with us to 2 p.m. Bless you.
Bless you. Thank you so much.
Amen. All right. Next prophet, please announce yourself.
Prophetess Grace Asquith. Good afternoon, Prophet Stephen Brown.
All right. We have Prophet Grace Asquith. Amen. Blessings to you. You are number 19.
Thank you. I received the blessing, and I'll be here until 2:30 p.m.
Number 19, Prophet Grace Asquith is with us to 2:30 p.m. Amen. Thank Next prophet.
Prophetess Rosie Critchlow to 2 p.m.
Prophet Rosie Critchlow is with us to 2 p.m. Prophet Rosie Critchlow is with us to 2 p.m. Bless you. Number 20. Next prophet.
Prophetess Irene Davenport until 3.
Prophet Irene Davenport, bless you, is here to 3 p.m. You're number 21.
Thank you for the blessing.
Oh, bless God. Amen. Next prophet.
Good afternoon. This is Prophetess Mary Shin.
Prophet Mary Shin is number 22. Bless you. You're number 22.
Thank you.
Amen. Next prophet. Amen. Anyone else?
Prophetess Nikki Blaine.
All right. So this is what I have so far. We have number one, Prophet Worthy Class Master Deborah Jordan. Number two, Prophet Nichelle Berrien here to 2:30. Number three, Prophet Antoinette Harris here to 2 p.m. Number four is Prophet Stephen Brown. That's me. Number five and six is Prophet Valina and David Bratton. Number seven is Bishop-elect Joshua Jordan. Number eight is Prophet Olympia Castillo. Nine is Prophet Iris Green. 10 is Prophet Linda Green, who's with us to 2 p.m. 11 is Prophet Evelyn Lilly. 12 is Prophet Barbara Tucker, and she will be doing the prayer this morning. 13 is Prophet Yolanda Rojas. 14 is Prophet William Richards. 15 is Prophet Pat Green. 16 is Prophet Denise Bullock, who will start at 2 p.m. 17 is Prophet Latoya Dawkins, who's with us to 4 p.m. 18 is Prophet Xavier Quarterman, who's here to 2 p.m. 19 is Prophet Grace Asquith, who's here to 2:30. 20 is Prophet Rosie Critchlow, who's here to 2 p.m. 21, Prophet Irene Davenport here to 8 p.m. 22 is Prophet Mary Shin. Are there any other prophets joining us in the lineup today?
Prophetess Nikki Blaine.
Who's that?
Prophetess Irene Davenport. I'm here to
You're here to 3 p.m. Noted. Number 21, Prophet Irene Davenport is here to 3 p.m. Any other prophets joining us in the lineup?
Worthy Class Master Gloria Jean Kelly.
Amen. Number 23 is Worthy Class Master Gloria Jean Kelly. Amen. Amen and amen. All right. And do we have any other prophets joining us in the lineup?
Prophetess Nikki Blaine.
Amen. Prophet, say your name again.
Natasha Smith.
Prophet Natasha Smith is 24. Did I hear another voice? Number 25?
Yes, Prophetess Nikki Blaine.
Prophet Nikki Blaine?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yep, you are number 25. Bless you. Next prophet? Anyone else?
Anyone else?
Prophet Sherman Pegues.
Number 26 is Prophet Sherman Pegues. Bless you. You are number 26. Amen and amen. Any other prophets joining us in the lineup? Hallelujah to God. Hallelujah to God. Well, people of God, this is the order of service for this glorious Sunday. Amen and amen. I want you to get ready. Amen. Because we're going to have a great time in the Lord. And it's what you put in. That's what you're going to get out of it today. We thank the Lord for this wonderful day. Amen. So today, scripture reading, I'm going to do the scripture reading today. Amen. Right after the scripture reading today, we're going to have prayer. by Prophet and Deacon Barbara Tucker. And right after that, we're going to go into the offering time with Deacon Olympia Castillo and Deacon Jennifer Mobley. Amen and amen. And I want everyone to go ahead, those that are watching on YouTube, Facebook. Well, if you're on YouTube, whether you're on Bishop Jordan YouTube channel or Zoe Ministries YouTube channel, this is what I would like you to do. I want you to right now to like and comment, shout out your city and state. Let us know where you're watching us from. I'm also going to ask the Zoites to be in the YouTube channel. Amen. As well, watching that YouTube channel as well. I want everyone to participate. If you're on Facebook, would you go ahead and attach this, repost this on your page, invite people to watch this prophetic experience today. Amen. I want everyone to do that. And I got some good news. I want everybody to go to zoeministries.com because guess what? The Master Prophet next week is coming to Chicago, Illinois. You want to know more about Chicago, Illinois and the Master Prophet? He's there for 2 days. Go to zoeministries.com and find out for yourself when the Master Prophet is coming to Chicago. I said the Master Prophet is coming back to the Midwest, and you want to be a part of those two special events. Go to zoeministries.com or bishopjordan.com. You will see all the information regarding those two powerful prophetic dates in the month of October. That's right around the corner. That's next week. Amen. Want to give some time? Are there any other prophets joining us in the lineup today? Any other prophets? All right. Well. I'm so glad that Jesus lifted us. Glory, hallelujah. Jesus lifted us. Amen. We're going to go into the scripture. I'm going to open up. Yeah, who's speaking?
Prophetess Diamond King, you had just asked, was there any other prophets? And I would like to be added to the lineup. I started two on the background doing one-on-ones.
Sorry, okay. 27, Prophet Diamond King, starting at what time, 2?
2 p.m., yes, sir.
Noted. Amen. Starting at 2 p.m. Wow. Amen and amen. All right. We're going to go to... Prophet, I want this in King James. Say that again.
Prophet Sheila Levy.
28. Prophet Sheila Levy. Amen. Anyone else? Anyone else? All right. Today's scripture reading, I'm going to be reading out of the New International Version of the Bible, John, chapter St. John. 14, beginning at verse 15 to the 21st, it says, if you love me, keep my commandments, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to help you and be with you forever. The Spirit of truth, the world cannot accept him, because it neither sees him nor knows him, but you know him, for he lives with you and will be in you. I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you, and before long the world will not see me anymore. But you will see me because I live, you will also live. And on that day you will realize that I am in my Father, and you are in me, and I'm in you. Whosoever has my commandments and keeps them is the one who loves me. The one who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I too will love them and show myself to them. Amen. Prophet Deacon Barbara Tucker will lead us in prayer.
Amen. Father God, we thank you for that reading of your word, Father God, for you are the word that lives in truth. You are truth, Father God, and we thank you, God, for we love you, God, for you have first loved us. Now, Father God, we thank you for this day that you have made, that we are able to rejoice in this day, Father God. Thank you for this ruach breath of life that we can breathe life, Father God, and we can breathe a hallelujah. Hey, glory, hallelujah. We thank you for this day, Father, that you have assigned us our leader, Dr. E. Bernard Jordan and Pastor Prophetess Deborah Jordan and the Jordan Dynasty, Father God, that the truth and the word goes through them. Now, Father God, we are open. We receive you today. We receive this word. We receive revelation. We receive healing where healing is needed, Father God. We receive increase. We have an ear to hear what you're saying on this day. Now, Father God, every minister, prophet, deacon, Father God, elder, Father God, touch them, Father God, and renew in them even, Father God, your visitation, Father God, in their life. Touch the families extended and even Princess Linda, Father God, her country. Bless her country, Father God, and bless this woman who stands to be a witness to the prophetic in her life and for her country, Father God. We thank you, God. We thank you, God, and we want your will to be done, not our will and your way, God. Thank you for purpose. Thank you, God, for assigning us, Father God. Thank you, God, for choosing us, Father God. We bless you for this the day, again, that you have made, and we can rejoice in this. We are so exceedingly glad, Father God. We thank you for life, salvation, deliverance, healing, Father God. We thank you, God. Well, we're jumping in, Father God. No inhibitions. We're just here, God, to be vessels, God. And we thank you for the turnaround. I can feel it already, for God, you are in the midst. And we thank you for touching our households, God. We thank you also for seed that you give to the sower, that we may undergird and hold up high. Glory, hallelujah, our leader, Father God. America's Black Prophet. Oh, yes, and yes, and yes. We thank you, God. We thank you, God, and we give you the praise in your mighty Son's name. Thank you, Father God, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah and glory to God. Amen and amen. The ministry of worship, and that is in tithes and offerings in Tarumah. Amen. Deacon Olympia Castillo, please make your way to the stage. Amen. And Deacon Jennifer Mobley at this time. Amen. Get excited, people of God. We are moving forward. Amen. In this time, we're going to bless God with our tithes and offerings. Amen. Prophet Olympia, I'll keep on talking until I see you on the screen. You're on your way up?
Yes and yes.
Amen. All right. She's on her way up. But in the meantime, go ahead, get your seed in your hand. Go ahead and sow it. Amen. Don't forget to do your Tarumah. Amen. And you can just turn off your speaker until you're ready to come on. All right. And she's there. Amen. Prophet, Deacon Olympia Castillo, take it away. Mute yourself.
Amen. Thank you so much. Amen. I'm excited to share on the worship on this morning. And we know that it's a powerful thing to share and to also worship God with our seed. We know seed brings life. The seed brings understanding. The seed brings protection for our family. And Deacon Jennifer Perry, are you up on the screen as yet?
I am sharing my screen.
Amen and amen. All right. So we are excited, and my avatar is just doing what it wants. Amen. All right. So I'm going to begin to share on how to give to the mouth of God, which is our supervising priest, Dr. E. Bernard Jordan. Amen. And we know that's at the Tarumah seed, that salt covenant. We know that that's the tide of the tide. Amen. So the Tarumah is spelled T-A-R-U-M-A-H. Amen. And I want to read a Bible scripture from Ezekiel 44, verse 30, and it reads, "And the first of all, the first fruits of all things, and every oblation of all, of every sort of your oblations, shall be the priest. Ye shall also give unto the priest the first of your dough, that he may cause the blessing to rest in thine household." Now, wouldn't you want to have a blessing that rests in your household all the time? Not just one day, not just 2 days, amen? But we want that blessing to rest in your household. And it'll happen when you release that Tarumah seed. Also, we want to let you know that you can download the Tarumah app by going to the Google Play Store or the Apple Store. And we know again that that teruma will calculate the 2.5%. Amen. If you want to know more information about the teruma seed, you can download the book by going to the Master Prophet's website, and it will definitely teach you the relationship between the priest and the people of God. And again, that teruma will calculate any amount that you put in, whether it's your benefits or whether it's a salary. It will calculate the 2.5%, but if you want to be really bold, you can do that 5%, amen, that double honor. It will also calculate 10% for your tithes, 1/3 for your pilgrimage, 1/3 for the poor and needy, and 1/3 for your pilgrimage, amen, your retirement, I'm sorry. And well, these are the ways you can release your teruma seed on this afternoon. The first way, you can go to your banking institution and go right to Zelle Quick Pay. Just hit where it says send money. You can put the email address in, bishopjordan@zoeministries.com. Again, going through Zelle Quick Pay, you can put in the memo section, bishopjordan@zoeministries.com. Now, second way is through PayPal. This is excellent for our international partners, amen. Again, in that memo section, you can put bishopjordan@zoeministries.com. The third way is through Venmo. The spelling of that word is V-E-N-M-O. And in the memo section, you wanna put Bernard-Jordan-4. And if you don't have access to all of these and you want to do Cash App, well, you can do that as well. And Pastor Deborah Jordan's Cash App is $Prophetess Deborah. Again, it's $Prophetess Deborah, and she spells her name D-E-B-R-A. Also, Archbishop has his Cash App as well. You want to be sure to type out the whole words of his Cash App, because we have a lot of copycats out here doing some wrong things. But we want to make sure that our supervising priest, Dr. E. Bernard Jordan, receives the teruma through his Cash App. That name is $MyArchbishop. Again, $MyArchbishop. And the spelling is MYARCHBISOP. Amen. $MyArchbishop, amen and amen. And if you don't have access to any one of these apps, you can feel free to call our moderators at the customer care line number, and they'll be more than happy to assist you in planting your teruma seed on today. But be sure to let the moderator know that this is your teruma seed that you are planting, because this seed is definitely processed differently than the other seeds. And we also want to request that you do a $10 seed or more when you're releasing your teruma seed. We also want to let you know that you'll not receive a prophetic word when you release your teruma seed, nor will it be on your end of the year church contribution statement, and it cannot be applied to your Master Prophet's blessing plan, number 13. For this is a gift offering between you and your supervisor priest, which is Dr. E. Bernard Jordan. And once you release that teruma seed, he can now command a blessing to rest upon your household. And these are the ways that you can release your teruma seed on this glorious Sunday morning. Amen. The last Sunday in the month of September. And thank you for sowing your teruma on today. And now we'll have Deacon Jennifer Perry that will begin to share on how to give to the house of God, which is your tithes and offerings. Thank you, Deacon Jennifer Perry.
Well, thank you so much. Seems like I am having some challenges coming along, but I am more than willing and excited to talk about.
Amen. 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 Thank you so much, Prophet Olympia Castillo. All right. Amen. Well, listen, people of God, I want you to go ahead and get your seed in the ground.
Oh, Prophet. Oh, okay. Stephen Brown.
Oh, you're going to go into do the offering now.
Right. Oh, well, Deacon Jennifer was going to do it, but she having a little challenge with getting on the screen, but she can go ahead and say it without being on the screen.
All right, go. Yes, go ahead. No, that's okay. I'm going to do, I'll do it so because people can see me because we're streaming on different platforms. So thank you, Deacon Mobley. Amen. All right. Well, people of God, you know what the scripture says. God gives seed to the sower today. Amen. And if there's a lack in your life today, I want to tell you the way to get out of lack, and that is giving today. Will a man rob God? Absolutely. Amen today. But we believe in sowing the seed today. And so we bring our tithes, that 10%. But not only that, we bring our terumah unto the Lord today. And I want everyone to know that the blessing is in giving today. If you have the Terumah app, if you open it up, it'll let you know. You can count your blessings, you can do your salary, and it'll tell you the 10%. It'll give you the exact amount that goes into the offering. And it also lets you know what goes to your supervising priest, what goes to the poor. We believe in giving. We believe in sowing the seed today. Amen. The Lord loves a cheerful giver. This is not something you have to do. It's something you get to do. And it is an honor to honor God with your seed today. It is a delight to worship. Even as Abraham, amen, was sending his son up to be offered, amen, he said, we're going up to worship. His son said, where's the lamb? Where's the lamb? Where's the ram? And he said, the Lord will provide. But guess what? God has given provision for you. He's held back some dark days. He's held you from accidents. He's held death away from you. And today you want to give into your future. You want to say, Father, I worship you by sowing my blood, sweat, and tears, my offering unto you today. Why do you do it? Because it's saying, Father, I trust you as my source. Why do you sow? Because you say, God, you are my provision. Why do you sow? Because you love God. Now, remember the scripture that I read today. Remember the scripture I read today to you. Amen. Talking about the Holy Spirit. In that scripture, it lets you know that Jesus said, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments today. Give and it shall be given. Pressed down, shaken together, running over. Oh my goodness, today an act of your obedience shows that you love God. Your act of surrender, it's a heart situation. It's a place, a condition of surrender, of submission to the Father. It's not just the act of giving, it's the heart that says, Lord, I delight to do your will. That's why we give. We give because we worship God and we acknowledge him as our source today. Now, these are the ways that you can sow your seed into the ministry today. The first way you honor God, you can do it through, you can text your tithes and offerings, text the word my worship, make it one word, my worship, to 646-762-0433, 646-762-0433. That's one way to sow your tithes and offering. Another way to sow your seed right now is to go to zoeministries.com or bishopjordan.com. zoeministries.com or bishopjordan.com. Click on donate and you can sow your seed right there. Another way to sow your seed today is through Cash App, $MyZoeChurch. $MyZoeChurch. Amen. Everybody right now, go ahead, get your Cash App, $MyZoeChurch. Everybody, go ahead. You can go to the, you know what I love about the ministry website is that you can use your credit card or debit card on the ministry website. It's a secured website, but guess what? You can also use the PayPal on the church website. It's a special PayPal solely for the church ministry, and it's only on the ministry's website. So you can do that. You can sow your seed by going to the website as well. And then finally, guess what? You want to pick up the phone. You say, you know, I need to talk to a human. I want to sow over the phone. Call 888-831-0434, 888-831-0434. There are moderators standing by to sow your seed right now. Amen and amen. Well, this is what we're going to do. We're going to go to a song of worship, give you time to sow. I like to use text to give. Amen. I'm going to use text to give to sow today. I'm going to do it in real time. Amen. I'm going to go and I'm doing text to give. I'm going to text the word. I already have text to give on my thing, which is 646-762-0433. And I don't like to type out my worship because it's long, so I just do donate, D-O-N-A-T-E. I'm sending that to 646-762-0433. And then what happens, it says, how much would you like to give to Zoe Ministries? And then I'm going to put in the amount that I'm sowing. And then I press send. And then after that, it says, it's asking me again, do you want to sow this amount to Zoe Ministries? I'm going to type yes. And then it's going to say, would you like this gift to be a recurring? I'm going to put no, because I sow different types of seeds. Amen. And then right after that, I'm waiting. I'm going to get a verification. Thanks, Stephen, your gift. And it tells the amount has been received. And then automatically, a receipt comes to me. Go ahead and do that. We're going to go to a song of worship, and then we'll be right back.
I'm Dr. Alicia Lola Jones, and you are watching The Power of Prophecy. The power of prophecy, the power of
Welcome the Taruma Offering app. For us givers, getting organized and staying on track with our contributions has never been easier. Create an account using the email you already use with Zoe Ministries. Yes, you can calculate your salary or you can calculate your benefit. After entering the salary amount or the benefit amount and pressing go, specific amounts will appear with the suggested contributions for each category. To view your calculation history reports, tap the word history. To give your Taruma offering or your donation, tap the word give. So what are you waiting for? So turn on your mobile device and visit the Google Play Store or the Apple App Store and download the Taruma app now. Thank you.
Who you FaceTiming? You FaceTiming Jesus? You on the FaceTime with Jesus? What y'all doing?
Seed in the ground. You're getting our seed in
the ground. Oh,
you get your seed
you're
in getting the ground.
Their seed in the ground.
Wow.
Now, wait a minute. You can get your seed into the ground right from your phone?
Yeah, you can.
Wait a minute. Now,
text to give.
Text to give?
Yeah. Never heard of it? Never heard of it?
Wait a minute. Y'all look.
Text to give.
How do we do it? Come on, because there's some that have their phones out now too, and they want to worship. How can we worship?
Just go onto your mobile phone, type in 646-762-0433. And
all right.
You get in there, type my worship, and easy like that.
And there's a QR. You know, when you hold your phone up there?
QR code as well. Hold it up. Scan it, right?
A QR code.
There's a QR code.
You just got to put your phone right there on the camera, and then you just type it right there, and it takes you.
You don't do the website?
You don't do the website?
Zoe, because you can do that on your phone. Okay, go, pull it up on your phone.
Pull it up on your phone.
You go to ZoeMinistries.com. Okay, and click on that nice little blue donate button you just put in.
Or you can go to bishopjordan.com.
Yes.
And you can always click on the link there.
Or maybe they want to call it in.
Now you can call it in as well. We can call it in.
Moderators are standing by right now. Call in your seed.
Yes. And you can call it in at 831-0434.
Or the lifeline number. Now, we grew up on that lifeline number.
Yes, we did.
That lifeline number is older than you are.
Stop telling your age.
Okay, I'm sorry. 212-316-2177. Again, that's 212-316-2177. It's called with some expectation because God loves a cheerful giver.
Indeed.
And our seed is always going before us.
That's
God bless you. And remember that destiny
is not left up to chance, but it's a matter of choice.
Destiny is not left up to chance. It's a matter of choice.
Praise the Lord, this is Master Prophet E. Bernard Jordan. You know, I was thinking in the scripture, where were the hundreds of prophets hid? They were hid in something like this, the cave of Adullam. When they were running away, hiding from a false prophet. Today, I want to ask you about coming out of the cave. A cave is a place that has only one opening, but no exit. It's almost like the way out is coming back through the way you got in. No windows, totally enclosed, almost like going into the body of a woman. It's like a cave. But the cave can also be a place of birthing. In the cave where the prophets dwell is the place where birthing happens. You are next in line for the birthing of the future that is at stake. We don't predict the future. We create the future. And the future is created out of caves like this.
Anointed. I mean, this man talked about a black president way before Barack Obama went to U.S.
I was blown away by the prophecy. The prophecy hit all the marks and told me of my future.
I'm listening to this man prophesy to me. I just screamed, I said, I'm done.
That's the prophet again to hear from God. We were trying to wait and hear the rest of the word, but nothing else came. It was just
9-1-1.
But God gives certain people certain insight toward guiding in the flow of where God wants us at the time in history that he's put us on earth for.
Oh, you know, he's a false prophet.
We were called the money church.
The love of money is the root of all evil.
I did not go into the ministry to get rich. I got rich doing ministry.
It wasn't about taking a vow of poverty.
The lack of money is the root of all evil.
How can you even be a Christian and not preach the message of prosperity? Mary, Martha, and Lazarus, they were rich people, had big houses.
When you lack money, you lack choices.
You have money, you can do great things in ministry. Believe his prophets, and so shall ye prosper.
This is Bishop Carlton Pearson, and you're watching The Power of Prophecy.
Amen. We are back, and we're going to have a good time in the Lord. Oh, my goodness. I mean, did you get your offering in? Did you worship the Lord with giving? If you're just joining us, my name is Prophet Stephen Brown. I greet you on behalf of your most trusted name in prophecy, Dr. E. Bernard Jordan. Amen and amen. Well, people of God, I'm so excited about today. God's going to speak to us. Amen. And the master prophet. Amen. We're going to be unseating the prophets today. We're going to have a glorious time. I want to encourage you to go ahead and do your 222.22. Amen. Many of you are doing your $1,000 seed. Go ahead and get that seed in the ground. Amen. And you know what? Something else I want to remind people. We started something here at Zoe Ministries, and that we honor God with the $1,000 seed on our birthday. You might have seen other people do it. You saw Worthy Class Master Gloria Jean sow the $1,000 seed on her birthday. Amen. And as we are going into the month of October, all October birthdays, make sure, amen, set aside $1,000 on your birthday. Sow that $1,000 seed on your birthday. Say, Father, I believe you for miracles in this new year, my new year, my birthday year. Amen. Go ahead to do that. Everyone that's in the month of October, November, December. My birthday is in February. So on February 27th, my birthday, I sold the $1,000 seed. Amen. And get into the practice of honoring God on your birthday. Amen and amen. I want everyone to go ahead, get your seed in the ground. Many of you are receiving a text from the master prophet, amen, to sow your seed, amen. There are those of you that are to sow the $1,000 seed. Some of you are doing the millionaire seed of the $526. That's how much a millionaire makes within an hour today. And so you want to go ahead and do that, amen. Go ahead, sow your seed. Text the word "my worship" to 646-762-0433, 646-762-0433. Go to zoeministries.com or bishopjordan.com. Amen. You can go there and sow your seed as well, or call the partner care line, which is 888-831-0434. Also want to remind everyone to download the Taruma app. Within that app is the ebook written by Dr. Jordan on the Taruma. And all you're getting, get understanding. Why do we do the Taruma? Why do we celebrate, amen, and honor our supervising priest? What is that all about? Go through the scriptures, go through the text, and learn from yourself, amen. And all thy getting, get an understanding. And so that you can be in practice and receive the benefit of that blessing today. Download the Taruma app, and you can do that. If you have an Apple device, you go to the App Store. If you are an Android user, you know, I was backslidden and was an Android user at one time. I'm just playing with you. The Android, you just go into the Google Play Store, amen, to download the Taruma app. Another way, I want to encourage you to do the Prophecy Now app. And, you know, I did my tithe over the weekend. Amen. And right after I did that, a prophet called me. A prophet called me and began to prophesy the word of the Lord. Guess what? All of my prophecy, let me see. Right there, there's a list of all my prophecies in the Taruma. That's the presbytery right in there today. Amen. And then, if I want to do my personal prophecies by the master prophet, guess what? They're all listed there. in the Prophecy Now app, and I can listen to each one after the other continuously, or I can just listen to one prophecy by the master prophet. Everyone is there. Now, why is it important? Because faith comes by hearing and hearing God's word. And so you want to be listening to the word. You want to see it in your mind's eye and you want to see it fulfilled today. Get pregnant with the word. Your life is changing for the better because you, amen, are following it. So go ahead, get your seed in the ground. Many of you are doing the 222-22 or the 2,222-22. Get your seed in the ground. Amen. And then the master prophet said, those that can't do the 526, he said, well, do the best thing. Do the 426, the 326, 226, 126. I want you to go ahead, amen, and sow in faith and watch God turn that around for you. Watch God work it out for you in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. All right. Well, listen. As we're doing that, I want you to know that there are some special announcements, things that you need to know that are coming up. Amen. So you want to listen to these special announcements. And I want to tell you, before we go to the announcements, I want to show you something. For everyone, I'm going to ZoeMinistries.com. And I want you to go to ZoeMinistries.com. Amen. And I'm on my pad here. Amen. And I want you to know, because everyone in the Midwest, I'm talking to those that are in Chicago, Detroit, Indiana, and the surrounding states, guess what? The Master Prophet is coming to you. Amen. And so you're going to see a purple banner. It says Liberty Temple Chicago Masterclass introducing the 5G Prophet on October 2nd, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time. Archbishop, the Dr. E. Bernard Jordan, amen, and list the host apostle that's hosting this event, amen. The registration fees are there. It's going to be at 2233 West 79th Street in Chicago, Illinois, amen. And you want to know about the registration and package material and all that information, go to the ministry website and look up that posting. And then, so that's going to be October 2nd. Then the following day, on October 3rd, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, the Master Prophet is still in the Midwest in Chicago. It's Master Prophet, the Masterclass for pastors, leaders, and entrepreneurs. Dr. E. Bernard Jordan, also called the Master Prophet, will be in Chicago. Amen. On October 3rd, 2022, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time in Chicago. And you want information, you can text the word MASTERCLASS. Make it one word, no spaces. MASTERCLASS to 646-762-0433. And there's a special donation. This is for pastors, leaders, and entrepreneurs. And the fee for that is $2,022.22. All on the ministry website. So go ahead. Look for, when you go to Zoe Ministries, look to there's a section that says in-person events, and you will see those banners to that. Amen. I want you to check out these announcements. Amen. As we go further in this prophetic experience.
Grace and peace, I'm Prophetess Deanna, and I have some special announcements that you need to hear on today.
Register now for the Master Prophet's Blessing Plan number 13. As a member of the Master Prophet's Blessing Plan, you'll receive 5 exclusive textbooks, workbooks, written by the Master Prophet, Archbishop E. Bernard Jordan himself. Every month, you'll receive the Chef's Garden Box with fresh vegetables straight from the farm to your doorstep. Access to the Master Prophet's Library app, access to Prophecology Winter 2023, and special seminars and prophetic coaching on the Zoe Virtual Campus. You do not want to miss out on the Master Prophet's Blessing Plan 13. Register now by calling our partner care line at 888-831-0434. Once registered, your tithes and your offerings will go towards the Master Prophet's Blessing Plan number 13, which is only $5,500. Once you fulfill the Master Prophet's Blessing Plan requirements, you have the opportunity to go to the next level and become a member of the Mastermind for an additional $8,500. As a member of the Mastermind, you'll get exclusive access to seminars led by experts in various industries for those who are ready to expand their minds and businesses. Do not be left out. Sign up now. Call now, 888-831-0434.
Every Sunday from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m., the Children's Church and Youth Church will meet on the Zoe Virtual Campus. You can click Go To, then select either Children's Church or Youth Church. We are encouraging all children and youth to attend.
Join us on September 17th from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for the next Mastermind number 13, the Prophetic Investment Wealth Building Club on the Zoe Virtual Campus. This event is a forum of financial market education that will empower you to create and build wealth and secure legacy through investment ideas and strategies. If you're a member of the Mastermind number 13, you'll receive free access to attend this event. For all non-Mastermind members, it is an $8,500 registration fee. If you are joining us for Mastermind number 13, the Prophetic Investment Wealth Building Club, on Saturday, September 17th, 2022, from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on the Zoe Virtual Campus, then register now on zoeministries.com. Click on Prophecology tab, then click on Mastermind number 13. You do not want to miss out on the prophetic experience because there's money in the mouth of the prophet. See you there.
Every day, join the Master Prophet and the Company of Prophets for our 24-hour prophetic revival. You can listen to teachings by the Master Prophet and the Company of Prophets, as well as receive live prophetic updates. You will also receive prophetic words from the Company of Prophets when you sow your seed to the ministry. Call in at any time of the day at 515-604-9266. Join our leading lady, Pastor Prophetess Deborah, for the midnight prayer call. On Mondays, the call is led by the men. Tuesdays, Mothers Always Praying. On Wednesdays, WOW, Women Only Wednesdays. Thursdays, All Are Welcome, led by the Temple Seers. And Fridays are led by the women. Saturday and Sunday, all are welcome. If you have a prayer request, submit your prayer request on PastorDeborahJordan.com. Then join us at 12 a.m. Eastern Standard Time by dialing 515-604-9266. All are welcome. Are you in need of prophetic direction for your life? If you're a part of the Master Prophet's Blessing Plan 12, you can sign up now for our 15-minute coaching sessions with the prophetic coaches on the Zoe Ministries virtual campus today. Call 888-831-0434 to schedule your appointment now. If you have not already done so, go to zoeministries.com and download the Zoe Ministries virtual campus. Did you have a prophetic experience recently? Did your word come to pass received by the Master Prophet and the Company of Prophets? Share your testimony with us today by emailing it to media@zoeministries.com. We want to share your testimony with our partners and social media platforms. Join us every third Sunday for Holy Communion during our 12 p.m. service. Have your communion elements ready.
Are you called to be a prophet? Join the Seekers meeting daily at 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time or 9:30 p.m. to 10:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time in the Seekers room on the Zoe Virtual Campus. The Master Prophet is looking for 120 new prophets to join the Prophetic Order of Mar Elijah. Will you be one of them? If you're currently a member of the Prophetic Order of Mar Elijah, the Master Prophet has need of you. Sign up for the Prophets on Call to support the Master Prophet on live social media platforms, including Facebook and Clubhouse. Please note, to participate, you must be cleared on the Prophecy Team Calls. Email Prophetess Janice Goss at jgoss@zoeministries.com and note Prophets on Call in the subject line.
You can now listen to Master Prophet E. Bernard Jordan's weekly podcast, Prophecology the Podcast, where the Master Prophet interviews experts in various fields such as ministry, health and wellness, business education, social justice, and more. You can listen on your preferred streaming platforms such as Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, iHeartRadio, or the TuneIn app, or you can listen on the ZoeMinistries.com or BishopJordan.com. Remember to subscribe, like, and share Prophecology the Podcast. Are you on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, or YouTube? Stay connected by liking and sharing Bishop Jordan, Pastor Deborah Jordan, and Zoe Ministries Church on Facebook. Follow and repost us on Instagram at Archbishop_Jordan, at Pastor Deborah, and at Zoe Ministries Official. Follow and retweet us on Twitter at Bishop Jordan and at Pastor Deborah. Last but not least, subscribe, like, and share to our YouTube channels, Zoe Ministries and Bishop Jordan, to get all of the latest updates. Learn how to calculate your Terumah seed. Download the Terumah app today. Listen to your prophetic words from your one-on-ones with the Master Prophet and the Company of Prophets. Download the Prophecy Now app. Both apps are available on Google, Apple, and Amazon. Download it now and tell a friend. If you are a part of the Master Prophet's Blessing Plan and the Mastermind, download the My Mastermind Journey app. It allows you to track your intentions, and the app is based on the Master Prophet's work. On the My Mastermind Journey app, it's easy to sign up. You can create an account using the email address that you use with Zoe Ministries. You can create your personal profile by following the prompts and answering the questions about yourself, including your name, gender, email address, and phone number. You can view your daily action steps by tapping the intentions icon, add an action step to your list of daily intentions, tap on the action step, or you can create your own custom action step by tapping on create custom action step. Type in the name of the action step and assign it to one of the four categories and choose an icon. You can also add a reminder for yourself. Get your progress reports by tapping on progress to monitor your progress on a daily, weekly, monthly, or yearly basis. Let's master our minds by downloading the My Mastermind Journey app, available in the Apple App Store and Google Play Store. The September anniversaries are as follows. Happy 35th wedding anniversary to Prophetess Bessie Allen and Prophet Eddie Allen. The September birthdays are as follows. Brother Jason Clark, Sister DeFrancis Martin, Sister Sylvanus Latoyson, Prophetess Candace Taylor, Prophetess Mary Denise Shin, Brother Sean McMillan, Prophetess Annette Parkins, Prophetess Naya Cook, Prophet Dante Marks, Prophetess Kathy Curry, Sister Valeria Saunders, Minister Gregory Clark, Prophetess Tanisha Johnson, Prophet Jeremiah Campbell, Prophet Lonnie Eatman, Prophetess Bethany Jordan, Brother Arnold Pinnix, Sister Paulette Broach, Prophetess Rhonda Jackson, Brother Joseph Foster, Michelle Beecham, Mother Cleola Williams, Moderator Rochelle Avenado, Sister Joylyn Smith, Sister Rose McCree, Sister Stephanie Peacock, Prophetess Kimberly Warren, Tova Hunter, Sister Jeanette Bayardell, Prophetess Naomi Cook, Prophetess Juanita George, Deacon Howard Ellison, Prophetess Pamela Allen, Bishop Jeremy Thompson, Liam Crooks, Brother Michael Richardson, Prophetess Gail Uzel, Prophetess Linda Green, Prophetess Angela Baker, Sister Lisa Newell, Prophetess Glennis Shannon, Minister Tiny Machiavelli, Prophetess Glenda Freeman, Sister Kwafi Gray, Prophetess Teresa Windham, Prophetess Irish Jones, Sister Jordan Clark, Prophetess Bessie Allen, Brother Edward Franklin, Sister Deborah King, Prophetess Donna Brown, Sister Anne Sonier, Prophetess Janaea Clark, our very own Prophetess and Sniper, Elder Gloria Jean Kelly, and none other than Her Grace, Bishop Lilia A. Bain. Happy birthday from your Zoe Ministries family. If you have a birthday or anniversary coming up and are a member of the Master Prophet's Blessing Plan, please send your headshot to info@zoeministries.com so you can be included in future birthday and anniversary celebrations. This concludes our service announcements. Thank you.
Hello, this is Pastor John V. Key, and you're watching The Power of Prophecy.
The Spirit's telling me to say something. Point at the prophet and point at his mouth. And let me hear you say, there is money in the mouth of the prophet. There is success in the mouth of the prophet. There is prosperity in the mouth of the prophet. There is deliverance in the mouth of the prophet. There is salvation in the mouth of the prophet. There is problem solving in the mouth of the prophet. And what the prophet does is to believe God. Also in the Bible, the prophets are called seers. S-E-E-R. Because the prophet sees things and speaks things and speaks them into existence. Now there are two things here. There is consistence and existence. The prophet sees all of the good that consists in God and speaks it into existence for you.
Amen and amen. God bless you. And we are back. Amen. Before we go into the unseating of the prophets, amen, I want to introduce you, amen, to a special invitation to the prophetic. That is the prophetic order of Mar Elijah. Amen. We're going to ask for our prophet, Antoinette Harris, to come to the screen. Amen. All right, because we have a special announcement to just let you know what's happening here at Zoe Ministries. Amen. You watching here, there's a poll. There's a prophetic poll for you to be here today, and it's not by accident. At this time, I want to introduce you to Prophet Antoinette Harris. Good afternoon, Prophet Antoinette Harris.
Good afternoon, Prophet Stephen. How are you?
Wonderful.
Well, I'm excited to be here today. It sounds like a power-packed day over there in Manhattan in the second location. And what an honor it was this morning to hear from the princess of Swaziland. That was so amazing. And royalty touched us once again. So I'm so grateful for the opportunity to be able to see her and honor the Master Prophet for a word that will definitely come in its due season. And so all things are in place when that word comes forth. So I'm here to speak to you about the Seekers Class. Why do I need to speak about the Seekers Class? If you are called to be a prophet, this is a place that you might consider coming to. Why? Because this is where the prophets are trained that are assigned to this particular order. Now, we understand that being a prophet is an assignment. Being a prophet is a calling. However, the office of a prophet is the calling upon the prophet, because pretty everyone is a prophet. Whatever is in your life, you talked about it, you brought it to your reality, you brought it into manifestation. So here, what we're speaking about is the office of a prophet, which requires a discipline. And usually in the training, you begin to start at the foundation, which is about spiritual protocol. That's a very key point in the office of a prophet. So if you weren't quite sure about the office of a prophet and being a prophet, there is a distinction. So here in the prophetic order of Mar Elijah, we are talking about all of the distinctions around the prophetic office. Now, if you really want to know what that looks like, look at the movie The Crown. It really gives you a synopsis of how important the office is, and it will require something of you. Yeah, I guess you say, Lord, how much do you want? But yeah, I want all of it. I hear the Lord say, I want all of it, right? So when you know you're called, you're willing to submit. And so that's really part of the power of your stand, is that you understand protocol. And so we are teaching that. We're fellowshipping around spiritual protocol and School of the Prophets 1 and School of the Prophets 2. You have an opportunity to see what's behind door number 1, door number 2, and door number 3. So we're excited because in this process, there is a day that is coming to you. As the princess was saying this morning, the word that she got from the prophet happened 20 years later. What does that mean? God's word is alive. It is alive. And I guarantee you, when you are sowing a seed, the seed gives permission for that word to be unlocked and to be causing you to be in a place where all things are ready when the mind is so, and when God says this is the due season. So whatever's been spoken to you, hold on to that word and believe that God will come from behind you and push you forward and let you know this is the day. This is the day that this word will be manifested. So I'm so excited about every word that I get, because every word that I've gotten has sustained me until the word came to pass. And I have many words that are yet to come to pass, but I'm very clear about one thing. I'm like, who was it? Prophet Ezekiel said, you know, when God asked him, can these bones live? And he said, only you know that. Only you know, Lord, you know, only thou knowest. Why? Because the thing is, God can do what he wants to do when he wants to do it. We are just a participant, as Master Prophet calls it. We are in the playground of the gods. Yeah, because we're actually showing up and God's doing all the work. So I don't know why we get confused with that, but God does all the work. And he just is looking for the disciplined heart and the steadfast spirit that is willing to be anchored until God designs the path, or until God decides which path he wants you to go in, and then you get to choose. So here we are in the middle of a seeker's class every day from 2 to 3 p.m. and 9:30 to 10:30 Eastern Standard Time. And why is that important? Because Master Prophet said, well, I'm going to give them a choice. You know, that's the power of being able to work with people. They need choices, right? And so you get to choose what day you want to come, Monday all the way to Sunday. So 7 days a week. And 2 to 3 p.m. and 9:30 to 10:30 is really where it's going to take place here in Verbella. So if you are on YouTube and you're saying, well, you know, I don't have Verbella, just call the moderator and the moderator will tell you how to access Verbella, and you will come into the Seeker's Room, and there we will register you there, or you can go online to bishopjordan.com and get registered for the Seeker's class on Verbella. So we're inviting you on behalf of Master Prophet and Lady Deborah Jordan. This is truly their life work. You know, the consistency and the integrity around the prophetic is something that cannot be denied. And so regardless, this is a work that has been in the earth and is moving through the earth. And if you come in contact with this particular prophet, with this particular house, with this particular discipline, your life will be changed. No one comes here and leaves the same. So this is the power of the Holy Ghost that makes sure this is done. So if you are called to be a prophet, or can I say called to be in the office of the prophet, if you don't even know, show up 7 days a week, 2 to 3 p.m., 9:30 to 10:30 every day, Eastern Standard Time. And I guarantee you, we'll be holding a space just for you. Back to you, Prophet Stephen.
Thank you so much, Prophet Antoinette Harris. Amen. Well, I want to introduce you to someone that's special because she's been here from the beginning and with the Master Prophet. That's right. Amen. From New Jersey. Amen. To Brooklyn, to the Doral Inn and back. Everywhere. Amen. She's had an eternal. As a matter of fact, she's been in ministry longer than the Master Prophet. We thank God for worthy class master Deborah Jordan. Good afternoon, Pastor.
Good afternoon. Amen. It's so good to be here. And we done shift our little set around. It's looking fabulous. It's looking amazing. And we're just rejoicing. Prophet Stephen, we also have someone else in the studio. Yeah. Amen. Prophet Alexander Gray. So we need to put him on our list as well.
Amen. Add him to the list. Prophet Alexander Gray, amen. God's messenger in these days is number 29. Amen. Amen. The apostle and evangelist.
All right, all right. Alexander Prophet Alexander, how are you doing on this grand and secret Sunday?
Well, Pastor Deborah, people of God, I am tremendously blessed. And thank God that I am alive on this side of life.
I am Amen. Alive.
And healthy at that.
Amen.
And glad to be a part of the Archbishop, Dr. Ebenezer Jordan, and Pastor Deborah Jordan, and Zoe Ministries. What a wonderful place to be, Pastor Deborah.
Amen, amen, amen. To God be the glory. All right, Elder Kelly, are you in the studio with us? Are you with us? If so, can you please
yes.
come on the set?
I am here, thank you. Coming right up.
Amen, amen. And when Alexander, you talk about I am alive, we were at a Bishop Bond's 25th church anniversary on yesterday, and it was amazing. And one of these psalmists began to sing, I am alive.
Yeah.
And he said, you don't understand why I sing this song. He said, I was on dialysis. Mm-hmm. And they
Jesus.
Had said, the report was that he was going to be on dialysis for the rest of his life. Mm. A young man, maybe in his early 30s,
wow.
If that much. But he said, I'm alive. He's been off of dialysis.
Glory.
4 years this year.
Glory.
He began to give the praise report, what God did. And he was just thanking God that I am alive.
Yes.
And that spoke so volumes to me. And I just want to share that with the people of God today. Listen, thank God you are alive. You may not have what you want. You may not be where you want or think you should be, but you are alive.
Yes.
And as long as there's life in your body, there's breath, you're breathing in God's oxygen and breathing it out. Listen, you are alive, and tomorrow the sun will shine. The sun is always shining,
yes.
but tomorrow better days will always come
yes.
front and come your way. So having done all, when mm-hmm. I heard the song, Prophet Stephen, the scripture came to mind, having done all, we shall stand.
Yes.
Amen. Stand because we know in whom we believe. Stand because we know that we are alive and we are not here by chance or happenstance, but we are here by divine appointment.
Amen.
So listen, whatever you're going through today,
yes.
I want you to know today that this too shall pass.
Pass.
So
yes.
we give God praise. Amen, amen. Listen, we got several people that we're going to need to unseat the prophets. We got many people that have been calling in, sowing their seed, and we want to encourage you to continue calling in, sowing your seed. Why? Well, number one, you're sowing into fertile ground. Number two, well, the Bible lets us know that as long as the earth remains, that there will always be seed time and harvest.
Time.
And number three, for me, I take it to heart. I am in the business of giving. That's who I am.
Yes. Mm.
Whatever I give, I am always demonstrating to your name as we call off your name. Because these people, I believe today is going to be breakthrough day,
where
yes. we're going to go, not just make it to the top, but we're going to go over the top
Amen.
In the name of the Lord. So, Prophetess Kelly, how are you doing on this glorious, sacred afternoon?
Thank you so much, Pastor Deborah Jordan. I am doing absolutely wonderful. I, like yourself, I'm glad. I am glad to be here. I was glad and am glad to be in the house of the Lord. No better place to be at this particular point in time. I'm grateful. I'm grateful for my Archbishop, my Dr. Ebenezer Jordan. I'm grateful for you, Pastor Deborah Jordan. I'm grateful for the Zoe family. I'm grateful for the company of prophets. I'm just grateful to be here today. It's an honor and a privilege. You know, when I wake up each day, I realize that I'm only here to bring honor and glory unto the name of the Lord. That's my purpose here. That's my only purpose here. So whatever I do, I try to bring honor and glory unto the name of the Lord. That's my motto, if you will, or my mantra within as I come into any day and any given day. Why? Because God has blessed me
to be in the land of the living, to showcase his glory through me. And I believe he's doing that through everybody that's on this platform as well. He's no respecter of persons. So if you are here, your whole duty is to bring honor and glory unto the Lord. And that's what we're going to do. By honor, you understand what honor means, that we are to bring forth our worship unto him in whatever manner that is, at whatever level that is. That's what we're here for today. And we're encouraging you to make sure that your worship is in order, that your worship is in place. When I hear worship, I hear my worth-ship in the kingdom. And so this afternoon, make sure that your worship is in order. Make sure that you are in right standing with God. As your worship is in order, it puts you in right standing with God. Can I tell you, you have a right when your worship is in order to go before the throne of grace, looking for mercy to help in the time of need. And so this afternoon, let me encourage you, make sure that everything is in order as far as your worship is concerned. Why? Because then you have a right to stand before God. Listen, you have a right to be called the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus as your worship is. Oh, you know what? This is good. I feel something, you know, stirring up. So I'm going to come on back.
Hallelujah.
Go ahead. We're going to go ahead together.
All right. Amen. Amen. I'm old school, and while you were sharing, Elder Kelly, my mind went back to the song we used to sing at the church as a teenager, When I Think of the Goodness of the Lord.
Yes.
And all the things that he'd done for me, my very soul began to cry out, hallelujah, thank God for saving me. So, you know, truly this is a day that we can have complaints, or we can just say, well, this is not right, or that's not right, but today, we are choosing to lift up the name of the Lord and to give God all the praises. Why? Because he and he alone deserves the praises. And this is why it's so important that we talk so much about the seed, because the prophet is always connected to your seed. It's connected to life, because life only begets life. So Prophet Stephen, right before we unseat the prophet, tell the people of God to get their seed in the ground. We are believing God today for at least 12 people, the minimal of 12 individuals. Just say, you know something, I believe God, I trust God. God, you've been too good to me to not give you a praise and not to give you thanks by giving my seed today. We want to trust God that there'll be many of you that will give the $1,000 seed. Some of you said, well, you know something, I don't have that right. Well, I can only see 520. Say, I don't want to say don't have, amen, because we don't want to cancel out the good or what you already or getting ready to come in to your livelihood. So he said, but I could see myself giving the 526 seat, that millionaire seat, because I am a millionaire. Amen. If you're in the chat room, if you're on social media, any platform, YouTube, say, I am a millionaire. Because see, facts does not dictate who you are. God only dictates who you are. So Stephen, tell the people of God how to get their seed in the ground as we move forward.
Yes, indeed. And to get your seed in the ground right now, you can text the word "my worship." Make it one word, "my worship," or you can text the word "donate" to 646-762-0433. 646-762-0433. That's one way to do it. Another way to sow your seed today is through Cash App. Everyone that has Cash App, you can sow using $MyZoeChurch. $MyZoeChurch. If it's your very first time sowing your seed into Zoe Ministries using your Cash App, please go to zoeministries.com, click on the membership drop-down unit, go into Cash App section and fill out your information, including your Cash App handle, so we can recognize you and also say thank you. Amen. Another way to sow your seed today is to call your seed in. Call the partner care line. It's 888-831-0434. Again, 888-831-0434. Those are the ways to get your seed in the ground. Oh, and lastly, there is a QR code, a light blue and white QR code in the bottom left of the screen. If you open up your smart device to camera, put it right over the QR code. You know that QR card, many restaurants you go to today, amen, they may not have a menu. You see that QR code and you just put the phone over there and boom, you've got the menu. Well, when you take your phone Open up the camera, put over that QR code. It's going to give you the links to the ministry and the other ways to sow your seed. Prophet Deborah Jordan, Pastor.
Amen, amen. So thank you so much. Listen, we want you to do your due diligence in the name of the Lord. Amen. You know, I'm really loving my Zoe, the Cash App. Yeah, yes. That is really good. It's fast, quick, in a hurry, very smooth, very trim lined. So we have many avenues that you can get your seed in the ground on today. So right now we're going to get ready to unseat some prophets. And for those of you that have been having a question, is there a question today? The master prophet is here. He's on his way. He will be here momentarily. But as he's on his way to be in this service with us on today, we're going to do our due diligence. So when he comes in, the space will already been cleared, and he can go forth and minister the word of the Lord to us on today, because there is a powerful word that the master prophet has in his mouth for each and every one of us today. I believe you could not have come into this platform or this service except the Holy Spirit drew you. So there is a right now, a tailor-made word that's going to fit your situation. So as we are waiting for him to arrive momentarily, we're going to unseat the prophets so that space will be clear and ready for him to enter into in the name of the Lord. I know we have several of the prophets, Prophet Stephen, that have left at 2 are leaving at 2 p.m. And I know there's one person that's leaving out at 3, so I'm going to go ahead on and give you all the names. Prophet Irene Davenport, are you with us? Prophetess Irene Davenport.
Yes, I am, Prophetess Davenport.
God bless you. How are you doing?
I'm doing fine, thank you, and you?
I'm doing well. Thank you so much, and thank you for your faithfulness. I'm going to ask you, can you prophesy to two individuals that we have?
Yes.
All right. I'm going to give you Juanita George and Kenya Graves.
Thank you very much.
And thank you for your yes. Amen. All right. We're going to go ahead on. Prophetess Iris Green, are you available?
Yes, I am, Pastor. How are you?
I am doing well. And how are you and your husband, Prophet Marvin Green?
Doing great and great. And right now he is taking his rest. Came back from my work late, so that's what he's doing now.
Wow and wow. I'm going to give you two people to minister the word of the Lord to, and that's going to be Kali Carter and Rhonda Jackson.
All right, we see. Amen. Thank you much.
All right, 3 and 4. All right. Prophetess Evelyn Lilly, are you with us? Prophetess Evelyn.
Yes, I am, Pastor. God bless you. Good afternoon.
God bless you and good afternoon. And how's your granddaughter?
Getting bigger and bigger, and you can't say things around her if you don't want it repeated.
Well, she's of that age, yes, and she knows everything, yes, and she
Pastor.
Knows more than you and her mother.
Yes.
You do know that. But to God be the glory. It's good to have you on the call with us on today. I'm going to give you two individuals to minister the word of the Lord to. Keith Simmons and Tamu Cornelius.
Amen. Thank you so much, Pastor, and good to be on the call as well.
Amen, amen, amen. Thank you so much. All right. Prophetess Barbara Tucker, are you with us?
Yes, grace and peace to you, Pastor Deborah. How are you today?
I am doing well. God bless you. Love, as always, to hear your voice. Are you in the country or out the country?
I am home in Atlanta. Amen.
Excellent.
And if I could just say this, your smile is so beautiful today.
To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Thank you so much. I'm going to give you two individuals to minister to, Angela Baker and Juana Mooring.
Received, and thank you.
All right. All right. Prophetess Yolanda Rojas, are you with us today? Prophetess Yolanda Rojas.
I'm with you today.
God bless you, and thank you so much for being on the call. Can you minister to two individuals today?
Two. Yes.
All right. I'm going to give you Quinn Ellington and Dominisa Hurley.
Thank you so much. God bless you.
God bless you, and thank you so very much. All right, Patricia Green, are you with us, or can you hear us, or minister the word
of
the Lord?
Pastor. Yes, bless you, Pastor.
God bless you, and thank you so much for being on the call. I enjoyed your interview on this morning on the pre-show.
Oh, thank you.
It was excellent. I mean, it's like you are a natural. You did such a great job. All right.
Can you
call Prophetess Mascarene Cohen and Terrence Sams?
Mascarene, and thank you, Pastor.
And thank you so much. All right, we got several of the prophets that are leaving or have left. And Prophetess Latoya, she's coming on at 4?
Yeah, she's here to 4.
Oh, she's here to 4, so let me give her a couple of individuals. God bless you, Prophetess Latoya.
God bless you, Prophetess, Pastor Deborah Jordan. God bless you.
Amen, amen. Can you minister to a couple of individuals for us?
Yes, I can.
Okay, hold on. Let me give you them as we speak. I'm going to give you 2. Carolyn Wright. 13. And Tremika Parks.
Thank you. Got it.
Thank you so much. And come on back, because there's a powerful message and a powerful share that the Master Prophet will be sharing with us on today. Amen. All right, we got some other prophets. Okay. Mary Shen, I think she's next. Prophetess Mary Shen, we're out of...
Yes, good afternoon, Pastor Deborah.
Okay. God bless you, Prophetess Mary. How are you?
I'm fine. Thank you for asking. Good. And you look very beautiful, very beautiful.
You know, I like this color. This is honey blonde. And yesterday I had some type of reddish color that I wore, and it was all the way down my back. You know, 60, you know, feels really good. I'm not mad at 60. I'm in this season of exploring and looking, and said, you know, you can be many things, you know, like Jesus said, who do men say that I am? Listen, who do men say Deborah is, or define who Deborah is, or how she should look? So that's where I'm at in this season, you know.
Well, I love your definition and your redefinition.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that. All right, I'm going to give you, and how is that, Daryl?
Yes, ma'am. He is doing quite well.
I don't know why. When I look back up, I seen God touching his lower back and his legs. God is giving him strength.
He's actually going to see, Pastor, he's actually going to see the orthopedic specialist, matter of fact, this Thursday. He's been having some pain in his lower back.
Yeah, God is at work with that.
Yes, ma'am. I'll let him know.
Yeah, tell him we're praying for him, and we see him whole, completely, not just making it, but he is whole in the name of the Lord. From the crown of his head even unto the soles of his feet, he is healed by the word of the Lord in Jesus' name. So we see that in the name of the Lord for him.
Amen.
All right, so let me give you these 2. Okay, they don't mess my screen. See, why did they do that? I had everything lined up, and they done put some other names in here, so let me get that. Okay, I'm gonna give you Anthony Shannon and Alan Averett.
Yes, ma'am, received.
Okay. All right, thank you so much. And Prophetess Natasha, are you available? Prophetess Natasha. Okay, let's move on. Prophetess Nikki Blaine, are you available?
Yes, I am, Pastor.
God bless you. And how are you doing this afternoon?
I'm doing well, and how are you?
I am doing well, thanking the Lord, can't complain. I'm gonna give you 3 individuals. I'm gonna give you Reynold McZorn, Essie Brown, and Rhonda Campbell.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much. All right, our next, Prophet Sherman Pegues. Prophet Sherman Pegues, are you still with us? All right. Prophetess Diamond King?
Yes, Pastor.
God bless you. Good to have you on the call with us on today. Are you available to prophesy?
Yes.
All right. To God be the glory. Okay. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give you Veronica Bostic. And when you speak to Prophetess Veronica Bostic, tell her that Pastor Jordan said something. I see the pen and the pad in her hand. It's time for her to begin to write.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
but you, I'm going to give you Prophetess Veronica Bostic, Xavier Quarterman, Dominisa Hurley. So I'm giving you three people.
Yes.
Eight.
Thank you.
All right, thank you so very much. To 10, all right. Do we have Sheila Levy? Prophetess Sheila? All right.
And you don't Pastor Deborah?
Yes, God bless you.
This is Prophet Olympia. I'm number 8 and I wasn't assigned anyone yet, Pastor.
You know, on my list, I didn't put your name, okay. I erased it, then I wrote it on the side. Thank you so much. So let me give you these individuals. I'm going to give you three people. Thank you so much for reminding me.
Amen.
And I'm going to give you Cindy Ellis, Prophet Alexander Gray, and Marvin Green.
Amen. Thank you. Receive, Pastor.
Thank you so much.
You look beautiful.
Thank you. I kind of like this honey blonde.
Yes.
I am at 40, 50, that wasn't God, but 60, I'm saying yes to it.
Pastor, we're twinning because I had the same color on.
All right, to God be the glory. Great minds think alike.
Amen. Peace and blessings.
All right, God bless you, God bless you. Prophet Alexander, I'm going to have you also to make a couple of phone calls. I know you're in the studio, but a lot of the prophets, they left out, and I want to get this done. So when the master prophet comes, he's free. That and is, ready to minister the word of the Lord to you.
That is quite okay.
To the people of God. So I'm going to give you Prophet Alexander. I'm going to give you Sharon Lewis. I'm going to give you Adi Hill and Angela Gibson. Amen. And Elder Kelly, can I give you two of the individuals as well? And we will have completed our list that has been backlogged.
Absolutely.
I'm going to give you Prophetess Willie Mae Barnes and Douglas Miller. And let Prophet Miller know, don't lose sight of the bigger picture. There's a bigger picture than the picture that he's seeing in this season. Also tell him that's number one. And number two, tell Prophet Miller that he's in the stretch. And because he's in this stretch, he cannot go back. But tell him that God is stretching him in this season. And tell him, yes, he's going to feel the stretch, but it's a stretch for his betterment. Those are the two things to let him know. That
yes,
there's another bigger picture that God is going to bring his way. And where others would be saying, woe, is it me? Why am I not prospering? He's going to be on the other side rejoicing and praising the Lord.
Okay, amen. I've got the message. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Okay, I believe we got, let me see if there's any more.
Pastor Deborah?
Yes.
Pastor Deborah Jordan?
Yes. Okay, was that Prophetess Nichelle?
Prophetess Grace?
Yes, Pastor Deborah, God bless you. And I'm still here as well.
Oh, okay.
And you look wonderful.
Thank you so much. I thought they had said you was leaving out at 2 p.m., so that's why I didn't call your name.
Yes, I leave out. I depart at 2:30. Thank you.
Oh, it's 2:30. See, man. Let me see. These prophets, they want to prophesy. And this is so powerful. We have people that want to prophesy.
Amen.
Okay, Prophetess Nichelle, I'm going to give you Charisse Jones.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor Deborah.
And let Charisse Jones know, I don't know what she's going through, but let her know that doors are being opened for her, and tell her not to be afraid to step into these new doors. And I see these doors, I see an O over this, these doors, and this is not just a door, but doors, and it's a door. These are doors of opportunity. Tell her not to be afraid to step into these doors.
Amen. Thank All you, right. Pastor Deborah.
I almost feel like going out prophesying and coming
Deborah,
back.
This is Prophetess Grace Asquith. I am still here until 2:30.
Oh, okay. You know something? I took my list, writing it down fast.
Number 19.
Prophetess Grace. And what I did, yeah, 2:30. I wrote 2 o'clock opposed to 2:30. But thank you so much. Let's see if there's any other, ask them.
You look awesome, Prophetess.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Full coordination.
Thank you. It's a story behind this coordination this morning, but today. But nevertheless, because I was supposed to be in teal and white, but nevertheless.
Amen.
We give God praise.
Full coordination.
And it was a powerful lesson for me because when I looked, I said, Lord, I brought this outfit to wear for service. And for some reason, the sleeves wasn't right. I didn't bring all the cufflinks that I needed for the sleeves, and the sleeves, they were just hanging too long. It was just crazy. And I said, Lord, what am I going to do? And the Lord said, what's in your closet? I said, Lord, there's only a few things that's here. And as I went to my closet, the Holy Ghost began to show me, say, you're going to do this and this and this. And I said, thank you, Father. So it worked.
And
I said that to say to so many of you that are listening to us, whether you're on YouTube, Instagram, Zoom, whatever social media you are on, Verbella, that in this season that we are coming into, because the season has changed, whatever God is going to ask you and require, whatever is in your hand, you're going to use that. And many of you might be saying, but Lord, it's not much, it's little. But I dare you to use that, even as the widow woman at Zarephath began to use what was in her house. God is going to call and compel you to use what's in your house in order to bring your prosperity, in order to take you to the next season that God is calling you to walk into. It's a step up and a step out into a new season of greatness and prosperity.
Hallelujah.
So this is what God is doing and what God is saying. Amen, amen. Well, Prophet Stephen, I believe we have everyone today.
Pastor Deborah.
Prophetess Grace.
Yes, God bless you.
Prophetess Grace, Pastor Deborah.
And who is this? Female.
Prophetess Grace asked me and still hasn't been assigned.
Okay, well, I'm waiting for them to give me anyone else. You can look on your screen, too, to see if there's anyone else. As soon as another one comes in, we'll give that one to you, Prophetess Grace. But thank you so much for you being a yes.
Thank you so much.
Amen. I'm just going over the screen to make sure that we have called everyone. Amen. 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 You know, yes.
Sorry. Yes, Prophet Xavier Corbin. I can be around until 3 p.m. if anyone else needs to be unseated as well.
Okay, great. Because they have
18 noted to 3.
Okay,
so we're switching
to 3.
It to 3 p.m.
Okay, so I got you to 3 p.m. Okay, I got him to 3 p.m. Thank you so much.
To update the list. Number 18, Prophet Xavier Quarterman is here to 3
p.m. Yes. Okay, I don't see any more. Do you see anyone else we need to unseat?
So far, we have them all.
So far, we are complete at this moment.
Amen.
Amen.
All right,
looks good. Well, thank you, people of God. Yesterday was such a day.
Yes, tell us about it.
A busy day, but a productive day. And like I said earlier, we went out to Long Island to be with Bishop Bond. It was so amazing, so powerful.
Wow. And this is their 25th church
their
anniversary?
Their 25th church anniversary. And I believe this evening, they're going to have another big showdown. Choirs and different singers are coming in to sing and to worship the Lord in song. I mean, it was so amazing.
Wow.
And you know, Bishop Bond, I didn't know he could dress. He wore some knickerbockers.
Oh, well, watch the words.
He had this pink It was a pink outfit, but he looked so grand and so royal. Wow. It was so amazing until Archbishop Figueroa had to get out of his seat while the man of God is sharing and look around and say, what did you have on?
And you said it was pink?
It was pink. It's almost like a hot pink.
He wore hot pink?
It was fabulous. I don't care. It was their day. Pastor. He could wear whatever he wanted. It looked that fabulous.
Wow. A sight to behold.
Yes, yes, yes. And the people of God was there. They was rejoicing. They shouted. They had one young man there. He shouted. He had to be no more, maybe 11, 12 years old. Mm-hmm. He praised God in the dance and shouted before God because of where God had brought them from 25 years. So it was so amazing. Had a lot of bishops and pastors from all over that was there. And we just rejoiced. And when we got there, we were looking at the brochure and what was all that was happening, all the different awards that was being given out. And we seen our beloved bishop name. And he had to do, felicitations. Mm-hmm. So Bishop said, what is the felicitation? I said, I don't know, just give thanks, praise. I don't know. So he looked it up. And he found out that it was a word that you give to an individual as to a job done, well done, giving them praise that they were successful and what they went out to do. Mm. So it was very amazing, surprising, but yet amazing. And it was from 11 a.m.
Wow.
To 5 p.m. Oh, yes, 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. PM on yesterday.
You were there that long?
No, I was not there that long.
Okay, that's a long time. Jesus.
The person that, which I will not call a name, that was supposed to drive us, he didn't get to us too late.
Name him. No, I'm just joking.
Let's point him out. And then thereafter, because we're like in two places, the master prophet, thank God it wasn't us, it wasn't a woman. His bow tie, because he had to go in the tux. And we were saying, at first, no, this cannot be a formal event. No, you just wear something nice, you know, like church. So we called James Hall. We said, James Hall, what is the dress code? He said, the dress code, you dress because it is a gala event. Okay. He said, yes, it's from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m., but you're dressing as if it's after 6.
Wow.
And he had a woman there with this hat.
I can imagine.
It was, oh my God. Oh my God. It was somewhat of that, but it was just like a lot of flowers that was coming out.
Oh, right.
I mean, this high up on her head.
Wow.
And she was wearing it with style and with fashion and with attitude. So it was a great, a very grand event. I mean, it's powerful. And we just thank God that we are connected to great people of God. And we got back here, you know, Bishop wouldn't be Bishop. We're in New York City. This is the Episcopal apartment, mm-hmm. unbeknowing to me, mm-hmm. that he had invited some other bishops and pastors as well as Princess Linda Way. Those of you that was at the pre-show this morning, you got the opportunity to see her just sharing a little bit, and we did that private. Amen, because she is royal, of the royal family. So that was amazing. And she came by and shared, and we was just reminiscing the word of the Lord. And what we found out, though it tarry, and it may not, that word that you may receive, it may not come the following day, it may not come a week from now or a month, but that word is always, always on time. And she talked about how she was a teenager, one of the princesses, and coming to the service each night and writing down the prophetic word. And by chance, the prophet began to prophesy to her and began to call her how she was going to be the Esther of her household, being able to go in and out to see the king when others could not. And she began to share how that word truly came to pass, even during COVID.
Wow.
And different things, and how a lot of things that was transpiring in the country and that was taking place, and how and what God did. So listen, your word, you might say, but my word has not come to pass. Don't trash it, don't throw it out, but hold on to that word.
My God.
Because in the fullness of time,
fullness
that
of time.
Word shall,
yes, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus,
come to pass. You don't Thank have you, to worry Jesus. About it. You don't have to try to make it work. It shall come to pass. You don't need to try to birth an Ishmael. Your Isaac shall come forth. You don't have to worry, well, it's too old. Listen, that word should have came to pass. Listen, as long as you're standing in faith, trusting and believing, that word shall, glory be to God, it shall come to pass. Prophecy, what do you want to say about the word, Lord? Because God's word is so rich and so powerful until, like, see, we get caught up in time. And see, if you get caught up in time, time will have a tendency to tie you up and cause you to miss out on your day of visitation.
You know, Prophet Pastor, Stephen. The first thing I thought of, the scripture says that heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall stand. Yes, indeed, I am quick. And listen here, God's not a man that he should lie. If he said it, he will perform it. He will do it because he is faithful to his word today. And so when the word of the Lord comes to bring healing, bring deliverance, a prophetic word saying you're going to do this, you're going to do that, it's a sure word. It's us that has that needs to hear that word over and over again until faith is developed. It's us that is necessary to get that word and listen to it. That's why you need the Prophecy Now app. That's why you need to be listening to your prophetic word. That's why you need the Bible on script, the scriptures on audio. You want to constantly get the word of God in you and the prophetic word in your hearing. You need to hear it in the morning, hear it in the noonday, at night. Constantly hear the word of God. It's building faith. It's stirring you up to walk in what is pressed that has been predestined for you. You heard Pastor said that the princess sat in service and heard the master prophet said, you will go, you will be like Esther and go in and out to see the king. Let me tell you something here. Master prophet didn't know she was a royalty. And many times you are in a situation where God is speaking to you. They don't know who you are, but you belong to God. You represent the kingdom of God. Greater is he that's within you that is in, than he that is in the world. You represent a higher authority. And so when God gives you a word and said that your words will bring healing to others, or you receive a word that talks about owning real estate, or that you're to teach, or you're to write, amen. Why God does it? To remind you of your greatness that you are. And so that's why you need that word. You need to hear that word. I want to encourage your heart today. Amen. Many of you still need a word from God, and still many of you need a fresh wind of God to blow on you today. Go ahead. You know what? Activate your faith and sow into the ministry. Activate your faith and sow and watch God turn things around. There is power in the spoken word. There's a creative word waiting for you to change a situation. Even as the Spirit of God, God spoke, and the Spirit of God was brooding on the waters today. I'm telling you, the word, the Spirit of God is brooding over you and ready to create some things in your life, create some creative miracles in your heart today. Listen, the scripture says, as the deer panteth over the water brook, so my soul panteth after you. And some of you, you're in a dry place today. Some of you are in a place of desolation today, but the Spirit of God wants to blow on you fresh wind of creativity. Some of you need a refilling of the Holy Ghost. Some of you need to live. You've been stuck in a position and you think that's all that you got to do. That's all there is for you. But there's a second wind coming to you, a third wind for some of you to live and experience ministry like you've never seen before, and experience new places and heights in God today. God wants to breathe afresh on you. Don't get into the habit of thinking it's always got to be one way. Don't get in the habit of thinking that life is over, but there's a fresh wind coming. There's a new creative power coming upon you today. I want you to sow. Do the 222-22. There's some of you that need to do the $1,000 seed today. I want you to go ahead and do it because this is a new day, a fresh wind coming upon you. Amen. What happened yesterday is yesterday. What's that song? Anyway, I ain't going to do it. This is not the day for it. But listen, what is yesterday? I was thinking of a song. Yesterday has passed. Tomorrow is gone. But Lord, for my sake, teach me today. One day at a time. That's the script. That's the song I was thinking of, Pastor. This is a new day for you to sow into the ministry and watch God work for you. Text the word "my worship" or donate to 646-762-0433. Amen. And even as the master prophet, amen, is coming in, amen, his phone should be shaking because you remember your supervising priest. Amen. So go ahead and make sure the master prophet can feel you. Amen. And go ahead and get your to room. He's going to come back. Amen. And
You know, Prophet Stephen, while you were sharing, I don't know why we're talking about I shall live. And not only you shall live physically, but that prophetic word that God has spoken through to you through his prophet, that word shall live. And I just sense, let's just begin to prepare the ground before the master prophet comes. Now, I know we asked those that was going to sow that $1,000 seed, those that's gonna sow the $1 million seed, that 222 seed. But I wanna ask if I can get at least 33 people, because Jesus lived at 33, I believe he was 33 years old, that master seed of $100. Can I get 33 people right here, right now, to open up the windows of heaven?
Yes.
Right before the master prophet come in. We wanna stir the atmosphere. Hey, glory be to God. We wanna stir. Prophet Joshua Norton just came.
Wow.
We want to stir the atmosphere. We want to open up the winds of heaven. Can I get at least 33 people to say, Prophet Jordan, Prophetess Deborah, I'm going to join you with that $100 seed. It's a window opening seed. Can I get at least 33 people before the master prophet come and sit here and begin to give us what thus saith the Lord? Let's let this be a $33 seed, a window of heaven open seed. I want to open up the window of heaven. I'm going to I want to stir up the atmosphere. Amen. In the name of the Lord. Amen. So let's, if we can do that right now. And while we do that, I want y'all to put up in the window the different ways to get your seed in the ground. So whether you're watching us through social media or in Verbella, get your seed in the ground. Even those of you that are here in the studio, that $100 seed, the tithe, because I want to open up the window for heaven. My word, there's many words that have spoken over to me, and I want to see all those words come. I shall not die, but I shall live and see every one of those words come to pass in my life, in my day, and in my season, in the name of the Lord. We're going to go to a song.
Yes.
And after that, we're going to come back and we're going to rejoice. And I'm going to call up those that have given this $100 seed. I just felt led. If we can just stir up the heavens, give our angels an assignment. Amen. And when you give that, so that $100 seed, I want you to give your angel an assignment. Well, you say, listen, I need a breakthrough in my health. I need a breakthrough in my finances. I need something to take place in my family. I need something to be turned. Let that be your breakthrough seed for today, because we are opening up, we are stirring up the windows of heaven, amen, and creating that atmosphere so that God can move and have his own way in the name of the Lord. We're going to be right back. I'm getting ready to get my $100 seed in the ground.
I'm because God is the greatest power, we shall never, never be defeated. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never, never be defeated. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never, never be defeated. I shall rise, I shall be, I shall go in victory. No weapon formed against me will ever overtake me. I shall rise, and I shall be, and I shall go in victory. No weapon formed against me will ever overtake me. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never, never be defeated. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never, never be defeated. Declare that you shall never be defeated. Oh, never be defeated. You shall never be defeated. Come on, say, I shall rise. I shall be, and I shall go in victory. No weapon formed will ever overtake me. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never, never be defeated. Oh, and because God is the greatest power, never be defeated. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never, never be defeated. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never, never be defeated. The devil is a liar, God is exalted, I'll never be defeated, hallelujah, I'll never be defeated. Come on, sing, the devil is a liar,
the devil is a liar.
God is exalted,
God is exalted,
and will never be defeated,
never be defeated.
Oh Lord. Sing, the devil is a liar,
the devil is a liar.
God is exalted, and will never be defeated, we shall never be defeated. Sing,
the devil is a liar,
God is exalted, and will never be defeated, never be defeated. Sing, the devil is a liar, I shall never be defeated. We shall never be defeated. The devil is a liar. God is exalted. defeated. Even when I get weary, even when I'm disappointed, sometimes frustrated, but I'll never be defeated. Never be defeated. I shall never be defeated. And I speak over my life. I'll never be defeated. For I shall live. And I shall not die. I shall live. I'll never be defeated. Sing, I shall never be defeated. Somebody declare. That you'll never be defeated. No matter what comes, no matter what goes, we shall never be defeated. Never be defeated. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never. Never be defeated. And because God is the greatest power, I shall never, never be defeated.
You FaceTiming. You FaceTiming Jesus. You on the FaceTime with Jesus. What y'all doing?
He's in the ground. You're not in the ground.
Oh, get it.
Oh, oh, you get your seed. You're getting your seed.
Their seed in the ground.
Wow.
Now, wait a minute. You can get your seed into the ground right from your phone?
Yeah, you can.
Wait a minute. Now,
text to give.
Text to give.
Text to give, yeah. Never heard of it? Never heard of it?
Wait a minute. Y'all look.
Text to give.
How do we do it? Come on, because there's some that have their phones out now too, and they want to worship. How can we worship?
Just go onto your mobile phone, type in 646-762-0433. And
all right.
If you get in there, type my worship, and easy you, like that.
And there's a QR. You know, when you hold your phone up there?
QR code as well.
Hold it up, scan it, right?
A QR code.
There's a
wow.
QR code.
You just got to put
right.
your phone right there on the camera, uh-huh. and then you just... type it right there, and it takes you.
You don't do the website?
You don't do the website?
Zoe, because you can do that on your phone. Okay, go, pull it up on your
pull
phone.
Pull it up on your phone.
You go to ZoeMinistries.com. Okay, and click on that nice little blue donate button
the button.
You just put in.
Or you can go to BishopJordan.com.
Yes,
and you can always click on the link there.
Or maybe they want to call it in.
Now you
can
know
call
what?
It
Prophetess
in as
Naomi,
well.
We can call it in.
Moderators are standing by right
yes.
now. Call in your seed.
Yes, and you can call it in at 888-831-0434.
Or the lifeline number. Now, we grew up on that lifeline
yes,
number.
Yes, we did.
That lifeline number is older than you are.
Stop telling your age.
Okay, I'm sorry. 212-316-2177. Again, that's 212-316-2177. It's called with some expectation
right.
because God loves a cheerful giver.
Indeed.
And our seed is always going before us.
That's
God
right.
bless you and remember that
destiny is not left up to chance, but it's a matter of choice.
Destiny is not left up to chance. It's a matter of choice.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Time to get this mic back on. Amen, amen. Well, to God be the glory. Amen. Right now, we are asking for those of you that might have just came in to sow this open heaven seed of $100. 33. Why 33? Well, Jesus' ministry, 33 years he walked on the earth. 33 is also a master number. Amen. So we want to encourage you to get this seed in the ground. I asked for 33 people, but there will be more. And let me give you a name because they are. I know I got my seed in during the break. Right now we have Heavenly Ingram Javier. She did a $100 seed, amen. Stephen. We have Gwendolyn Mitchell that have done a $100 seed. M. Sean Lynch, $100 seed. Sean, I don't know why I just hear God said your creativity is going to come more and more to the forefront. I don't know what you do or the type of business or work you do, but I heard God said your creativity is going to shine. God is going to reposition you to get you in a place where you're doing the things that you love and not the things that you just have to do just to try to make a living. I don't know if that makes any sense, but that's what I hear the word of the Lord saying to me. Bernard McCain, God is bringing peace and victory unto you. Marilyn Hudson, she also gave $100 seed. I just hear God say, Marilyn, restoration. I want to talk about healing and strength, but I kept seeing restoration. So get ready. Iris Green, God said, get ready. God said he's pushing the both of you forward in this season. I got myself, I came in as number 8, yes. Doing the $100 seed. Nancy Dandy. Amen. Faithful partner, faithful woman of God. God said, continue to hold your head up high. And the writer in you is coming forth. I don't know if you have wrote or have written prior, but I see a book coming forth. I don't know if that's going to be another book or what. But God said, write. Testimonies. We also have Prophetess Glory Jean Kelly. Amen. Thank you so much, Elder Kelly. God said, victory is already yours. Just embrace it, receive it, and walk into it. Prophetess Rosie Crenshaw, these are our prophets.
Yes.
Amen. Our ministers, amen, that are sowing the seed, that have stepped out in faith because they know what 33 is. Yes. Amen. We also have Rosie Crenshaw, like I said. She's number 11, and she sowed the $100 seed. And Prophetess Rosie, I just hear God said, know this, that the promises of God to you is yes. And it's an amen. It's a done deal. We also have a Jamil Malone. Jamil, I don't know why, but something with the move is going to take place. Get ready because God is going to give you grace and favor. Linda Ward Graves. I just hear God say, get ready. Good news is showing up. I don't know why. I just keep hearing your phone ringing. God said, get ready because this is a season of great joy. Erica Mayfield, I just hear God said, turn around. She's number 14. Pamela Allen, I just hear God said, get ready for new opportunities. Number 16, Pamela Epp. Yes, we had a Pamela Allen, yes. And then we have a Pamela Epp. She's number 16. And God said he's bringing about restoration, yes, in this season. So we're looking for others to get their $100 seed in it. It's an open heaven seed. We say, hey, we're stirring up the heavens to bring about a shift that is needed.
Amen.
All right. We also have Prophet Stephen, number 17, Arlene Levice. She did not only did $100, but she did a total of $222. Amen. Seed and 22 cents. Arlene, I just hear God said, the family, God has not forgotten. The promises of God to you are yes. Get ready, said the Lord. Tawana Quayle, I just hear God said, I hear laughter because God said he's pushing you forward.
Thank you, Jesus.
And he's repositioning you. Vincent Staley, I just hear God said, things are going to turn. And know this, that things are not always the way they seemed or looked because facts are forever changing. We also have number 20, Deborah Wilson. Deborah Wilson, God said, having done all, stand. God said, you're not to give up hope, nor are you to lose heart, but you're to encourage yourself in the Lord in this season. All shall be well. Number 21, Prophet Stephen. And we still need another 12 other individuals. We need those 12 individuals. We want to open up the heavens before the master prophet comes. He should be here any moment. And we want to make sure this seed,
yes,
this open heaven seed has already been placed in the right places. And Dominisa Hurley, she's number 21, and she too gave $100. Dominisa, I just hear God say he's going to bless you for your faithfulness. And the legacy will not be lost, but it shall stand in the name the Lord. All right. We also have Prophetess Barbara Tucker. Prophetess Barbara, God said, your strength shall not fail thee. I don't know why I just hear this here, forever young. Mm. And not only you're going to say it, but you're going to feel it
yes.
in the name of the Lord. Number 24, we have Jerry Daniels. Jerry, God said, things are going to work in your favor. God said, declare it, name it, and embrace it, and it shall be yours in the name of the Lord. We have Stephen Brown, Prophet Stephen Brown. I just hear God say, he's opening up a great and effectual door for you to walk into it. This is your season to walk into it. Amen. Rosalind Wings, I just hear God say, you're the woman with the answer. Get ready, because I hear them, your phone ringing, and I hear them knocking at your door. God said, get ready. Strategic maneuvers you're going to cause the people of God to make in this season. Get ready, saith the Lord. All right, we also on number 27. We're almost there. Sharika King. Sharika, God said, get ready. Something with education is going to be very favorable for you in the name of the Lord. Amen. Come on, people of God. We want to get this open heaven seat open for the master prophet, because there is a word from the Lord, from our prophet, from our founder. Amen. The man that has the word of God in his mouth.
Amen.
Amen. But it's not just the word that our master prophet have in his mouth. It's always a timely word.
Timely word.
Ah, shadabusa.
Yes.
It's a word that's going to shift you. It's a word that's going to bring elevation. It's a word that's going to bring encouragement. Prophet Stephen.
Amen. People of God, you can get your seat in the ground right now. You're doing the $100 seat or more. Text the word donate, or text the word my worship, make it one word, to 646-762-0433. 646-762-0433. You can always go to the ministry website, zoeministries.com or bishopjordan.com. Click on the donate and you can sow right there. You can even use Cash App, $MyZoeChurch, $MyZoeChurch. And as always, if this is your very first time using Cash App, go to the ministry website, Zoe Ministries, click on the membership drop-down unit, go into Cash App and fill that information out so we can recognize you by your Cash App handle, amen, and say thank you. And then finally, call the partner care line, 888-831-0434. I want you to sow sacrificially, even though our leading lady said $100. Some of you, you need it for this hope in heaven. Yes, but
there are still others that want to sow more. Some are going to upgrade.
Yes.
There are still
more that's going to upgrade. This is just an open heaven seat. Amen.
Yes, yes.
Because we want to get that those angels that's on assignment to get them working. Some of us have had our angels on park.
Yeah.
And we get ready to shift them. We got to put them in drive.
Yes, yes. Amen.
In the name of the Lord.
And God always gives seed to the sower today, so you're doing that $100 seed or more. Go ahead right now. Amen. And sow the seed. You're sowing it using Cash App, $MyZoeChurch. If you're doing the text, I like the text. It's so easy. You're texting the word my worship, or you can just text donate to 646-762-0433. Amen. We're looking right now for your seed. We want to hear your name because the Spirit of God has a special word for you today. Amen and amen. Let me tell you something here. These prophetic words sometimes is something you didn't even think about. And God speaking to you, you're going to say, so glad that God spoke to me. I wasn't even thinking about going that direction today. Amen and amen. Leading lady, Prophet Deborah. Amen.
Amen, amen. Well, Prophet Stephen, as you were sharing with the people of God how to give, because the Bible says faith cometh by hearing and hearing by the word of the Lord. Well, Prophet Stephen, we also have some other individuals. Seem like my voice is going in and out. I'm going to get you to help me. Just a quick word. We also have Deborah Drummond. Deborah, God said he's stabilizing your resources. Ian Melville, number 29, God said right connection. I see right individuals crossing your connection. Partnerships are going to be very favorable. Prophet William Richard, number 30, amen. Prophet William, I just hear God said your strength shall not fail thee in this season. Number 31, Teresa Jeter, God said things are going to turn. This is a season of favor. Say and declare what you want in this season. Prophetess Evelyn Lilly, number 32, God said things are going to work in your favor, and God said his hand is upon you for good. I don't know why, I just hear God say, Evelyn, dream dreams. This is your time for the dreamer in you to become awakened in the name of the Lord. We also have Benita Bowen. God said things are going to work, and that's number 33.
Yes.
Wow. things are getting ready to change. Next year, this time, I just hear God say, get ready, because breakthrough is going to embrace you. Japanika, Cable, I just hear God say things are going to work in your favor, because favor is getting ready to kiss you upon your lips. Prophetess Alice Jackson, all is not lost. Things are going to turn. This is a season of change for you. Prophetess Patricia Green, number 36, excuse me. Patricia, God said, get ready. The writer in you. You know, I just see the company of prophets, the House of Poem, having books that they have authored and have written. It's going to be like almost the living epistles of themselves. And Prophetess Patricia, I just hear God said, write. Prophet Alexander Gray, I just hear God say he's opening up a pathway for you. New pathways are being created in this season. Renina Washington, number 38, God said, get ready. Push, P-U-S-H, because you're going to push until something happens. Carol Williams, I hear God said things are going to favor you in this season because God is working things out for you. Fear not, and that is the word of the Lord. And there's others of you that are doing this $100 seat. Heaven seat that he put it in on the shelf, called it I Don't Know. And in the fullness of time, because he didn't know in that season, but there was a season that was going to come that he was unaware of, that he was going to be in the know. And he pulled that word out. So this is a seed, this $100 seed is an open heaven seed, because your word and the prophetic word that has come forth in your life, it shall come to pass in the name of the Lord. Prophet Stephen, also the master prophet, was asking for those that's going to do that $1,000 seed. Yes. We're not dismissing that seed. You know something? I'm going to do my $1,000. I know I gave $1,000 seed the day before yesterday, but you know something? When you're in this anointing, when the angel of the Lord began to come, when the word of the Lord began to come and stir it up, then you got to get in it in order to embrace it, in order to bear witness, in order to be a part of what God has said. So I'm going to do my $1,000 seed on today, as well. I'm going to do another $900 seed. Why? Because I can. I'm demonstrating my divinity. Whatsoever the man of God asks, do it in the name of the Lord. Elder Kelly, what do you want to say about this stirring up this this ground today so that God can move and do what he has already said he was going to do concerning us?
I love this, Pastor Deborah, because God is a God of the overflow. And we are now in the overflow. We're in the press down, shaking together, running over. We're in the overflow. No place better to be than in the overflow of God. What does that mean? That means that there are endless possibilities that are open for all of us that are in earshot, all of us that have moved in faith, all of us that are standing and believing that God is able. Listen, whatever your situation is today, I would encourage you, go ahead and stretch it just a little bit. You know, sometimes when we stretch, it may hurt, but it doesn't last. That's what I love about the stretch. You might feel it in the moment, but in the long run, it's a good thing. It brings forth a change that's necessary. So maybe it is today that you need to stretch the seed. Yes, there were those of you that have stood with the $100 seed. Can you stretch it? There were those of you that saying, you know, the $1,000 seed is a little bit too much, but can you stretch it? See, I know for a fact that whatever you do for the man of God, God will do for you. He's going to bless you. Why? Because you blessed the man, the woman of God. And so when you sow your seed, it is just leaving your hand, but it will never, ever leave your life. You're going to see that seed playing out in your life over and over. And what I love about that is this, it's not just for you. It's for your family as well. So the things that you experience is not just for you. It is for family. And so today, can I encourage you that $1,000 seed, you know you should do that. Some of you are just sitting on it. For what reason? It doesn't matter, but you have it. If you have it, can I tell you something? It doesn't belong to you. I know. You say, well, it's in my account. Yes, it's in your account, but God just allowed you to have it to sit in your account to see what you would do with it. Are you really, really listening? Are you really worshiping me? If you have it sitting there, I can tell you that that's for you to sow. And when you do, here's another thing I can tell you. When you sow it, it creates a void. You know that. All you have to do is look in your account, and you'll see that your account is minus that $1,000. But what you have done is you've given God the opportunity to fill the void, because nature abhors a void. And anytime there is a void, it will be filled. Can I tell you? You create a void in your life today. As you sow that $1,000 seed, you're going to see that God is going to fill it. There will be no lack. And that's why you listen, you can't outbeat God giving. Whatever you give, he's going to give. He's going to give it back to you. And so as you sow the seed, you're sowing knowing that, yes, it's leaving my hand right now, but it is not leaving my life. Why? Because God is faithful to his word, and what you give, you're going to receive. And so today, wherever you are on the $1,000 seed, go ahead, sow that seed today. And as you do, you're going to see some things begin to break open for you. You're going to see some things begin to turn for you. You're going to see some things begin to shift in your life. Why? It's necessary in this season. So go ahead and sow your $1,000 seed. Those of you that are still wrestling with the seed, go ahead. Do your best seed, that $100 seed. And as you do, it's just going to be amazing what God begins to do for you. And again, what I love about it, you will not lack. I can't tell you at any time in my life where I've sown a seed and that I've lacked for something, I've needed something. There is no lack in God, therefore there is no lack in me. Go ahead and sow your $1,000 seed today. Go ahead and sow the $100 seed today. So we're in the overflow. I think we left off at I think it's 36, it could be 37. I'm not sure what the number is, but I know that number is growing. Why? Because you're sowing your seed now. Pastor Deborah.
Thank you so much, Prophetess Kelly. Elder Gray, what do you want to say about getting your seed in the ground? And there's other people that are being a yes to this stirring up and opening up the windows of heaven, because you got to be in it.
Yes.
To win it. So we just rejoicing in the name of the Lord. We're going to go into the overflow, because many of you have received a word from the Lord. And I'm here to testify and to tell everyone here today, whether you're on YouTube, Instagram, whatever social media platform you're in, listen, the word of the Lord is sure, and it shall come, yeah, to,
shall
pass.
Come to pass.
Prophet Gray.
Yes, you know, sowing the seed is very, very important, because when you want your season to change, you sow your seed. Your seed changes your season. Mm-hmm. 2 Chronicles 20:20 says, when you believe the Lord your God, you shall be established. But when you believe the prophet, you shall prosper. You shall move forward. Your seed moves you forward. It moves your cycle. It moves your season. It moves your life. Luke 6:38 says, give, and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over shall men give into your bosom. For with the same measure that you meet with all, it shall be measured to you again. Notice when you sow the seed, it says you do that act by sowing the seed, and it comes back to you seven ways. The book of Ecclesiastes chapter 11 says, to cast your bread on the waters. It'll come back many days. You don't know when it's going to come back. It says, sow your seed in the morning, sow your seed in the evening, and do not withhold it. Why? Because you don't know what harvest will come. It says, if the clouds are full of rain, they will empty themselves out. You don't know what seed that you have in your hand that is going to cause your cloud to burst. So when you sow that seed, you're positioning yourself for a change of a season, a change of a harvest, a change of a destiny, and also to divine relationships. Your seed can set you up for a divine relationship. All you need is one relationship. Remember, Solomon sowed the seed, and that relationship came in a dream. He became the richest man and the wisest man. I wonder what is in your seed. What is the hidden assignment and the hidden agenda that's locked up in your seed, Pastor Deborah?
Amen, amen. Thank you so much for that, Prophet Gray. There's other individuals that have called in their $100 window of heaven seat to open up the wind of heaven, to stir up the ground. Mm-hmm. You're cultivating the ground by this $100 seed. We want everyone to participate in this simple seed, but yet a significant seed on today. And I just want to lend our voices to that word, because every word, every seed has a signature, a DNA in it. Prophet Stephen.
Amen and amen. Thank you so much. And Pastor Prophet Deborah Jordan, amen. And we were sharing, amen, I believe her name, where is it? Renea Washington, who also sold the $100 seed. I hear the word of the Lord said, there's coming upon your creativity and your writing, and your word is going to go forth. It's like your name is being spoken of, and you're about to see some promotion. Get ready for that. Amen. And then we had number 39, Prophet Naomi Cook. I hear the Lord says, get ready, because this is going to be a time where your word and your action is causing exposure for you. Get ready for elevation and new contracts. All right. And then number 40, Takesha McQueen, who sold the $100. Takesha, I want you, the Lord says to tell you that this is going to be a time of exposure. Not only are you going to find real estate favor, but you're going to find real favor in terms of business connections. Get ready. Number 41, we have our leading lady, Prophet Deborah Jordan. Amen. Who sold way over $900. And woman of God, I hear the Lord says, there's coming upon you a second wind. There's coming upon you freshness, not only in creativity, but you're going to find God doing something in your physical body, because God calls you the healed of the Lord. Oh, and number 42, Prophet Mary Shin, I hear the Lord says, get ready, because you're about to see restoration. You're about to see a renewal in your spirit, and everything around you is renewed. There's changes happening for you. You're about to see God's hand of deliverance.
Thank you, Father.
Glory will be your testimony, and that's the word of the Lord. 43, Vivian Thomas, I hear the Lord says, get ready, because you're stepping into a new territory. You're stepping into a place of dominion. Get ready, because your word has become action. Your word is creating new worlds, and that's the word of the Lord. Amen.
All right, amen. I believe that's... No, we got 44 Tasha.
And there's so much more. There's so many more that are supposed to step into this flow today.
It's a window of heaven. See, I felt that. And my mind went back to the scripture where the angel will come down a certain time and stir the pool of Bethesda. And he will stir the water. And everyone that stepped, that stepped into this pool began to get healed. And I just felt that anointing, that everybody would step into this anointing, this open heaven anointing. We're stirring the ground. We are preparing it for our leader, for Dr. E. Bernard Jordan to come, because we believe that there is a word from the Lord. He has the word of the Lord in his mouth for us. And we're just preparing you to get ready. We're just stirring it up. It's like we're in this season of preparation, and we're just opening the invitation for all to come in. He that has an ear, let him hear. It's an invitation to step in and to participate as to what God is doing and will do concerning your life right here, right now. Amen, amen. Do we minister to Prophet Tasha Howard? Amen. I believe she's number 44, Tasha Howard.
I believe we did.
All right. And there's others. So we just want to invite you once again to come on in. We're going to go to a song, and we're going to be right back with the one and only, the most trusted name,
most trusted name in
prophecy, my best friend.
Hallelujah.
Your prophet.
Amen.
Your bishop, your leader, Bishop E. Bernard Jordan. He'll be with us when we come back. We're going to go to a song, and we're going to be right back, because there is a word from the Lord, and continue to get your seed in the ground and that $1,000 seed. All right, I'm going to upgrade mine to $1,000. I don't know about you, but let's just step in it and do what God has called us to do. God bless you. We'll be right back.
With you when you're not That's just his way. That's just the way he is.
He's nothing like your other friends. He'll be with you until the end.
'Cause that's just the way. It's just the way the Father is. 'Cause that's just the way.
Here.
And Prophetess Jessica Jordan.
Why the seed, Prophetess Jessica?
You know what? Why not the seed, Prophet Joshua? You know, when I begin to think about the seed, I begin to look at how the seed makes a way where it seemed there was no way, Prophet Joshua. Where the seed begins to go to places that I could not really access on my own.
That's right. And you know, the seed by nature is an overcomer.
That's right.
You know, you think about how many obstacles the seed overcomes in order to generate. And so if there's an obstacle in my life, I want to encourage you to put a seed on it, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, it's funny, as you begin to talk about the seed, I began to think of the word groundbreaker. And the seed is groundbreaking, you know? Have you ever seen a tree that's busted up a road?
Yeah.
A tree, right? It started out as a seed, you know? It started out as some small thing, and it managed to take and break up concrete, and it managed to grow and almost change the shape of everything else that's around it just so it can make a way through. And that's what the seed does in our lives.
So the seed can shift me from being in a hard place to being in a place that is groundbreaking.
That's absolutely right, Prophet Joshua. When you begin to look at that, the seed is so strong that it can begin to set you up in position such that the obstacles won't break you, but instead the obstacles around you have to adjust now to accommodate.
Now, Prophetess Jessica, what happens when the people of God do the $1,000 seed or more? Like today, the Dr. E. Bernard Jordan requested that there are many of us that stand in faith with that $1,000 seed or more. Now, Prophetess Jessica, what do we call that seed, and what's going to happen when they sow?
You know, Prophet Joshua, we call that seed the real estate seed, Prophet Joshua. And what begins to happen when you sow that seed, well, first off, you get a one-on-one with the Master Prophet, Dr. E. Bernard Jordan, and you begin to hear what thus saith the Lord for your life right on the phone with the Master Prophet. You have an opportunity to go ahead and ask a question. But not only that, the company of prophets begin to speak into your life as well. You'll get two phone calls from the company of prophets as they begin to also speak with us.
And as well, right there at the sacred desk, we will be sharing breaking news.
Yeah, absolutely. You'll hear Prophet Joshua.
Or Prophet Stephen.
Or Prophet Stephen, that's
or
right.
Whomever is at the sacred desk acknowledging that seed. That's right. That even the children
are beginning to cry.
Oh, my God, my God. It's a blessing. So listen, family, we want to encourage you, take this time, take these moments to begin to take advantage of the opportunity. God didn't see that. Worship, sowing the seed, is really an opportunity.
Absolutely, it is an opportunity, and certainly an opportunity you do not want to miss. So go ahead and take advantage and take an opportunity with many of the ways that we have so that you can get your seed in the ground. And you know, also, Good Ground's got a Cash App.
Good Ground has got a Cash
Good
App.
Good Ground has a Cash App. And so if you have Cash App, you want to go ahead and put in $MYZOE.
Well, wait a minute. It's My Zoe Church.
No, it's My Zoe Church.
It's Our Zoe
Listen,
Church.
Dollar sign
My Zoe Church.
And if it's your very first time going ahead and doing that, you want to make sure that you go to ZoeMinistries.com.
That's right.
And you click on the Members tab.
On the Members tab.
And fill in your Cash App information so that we can attach your Cash App handle with your name.
That's right. And listen, we want to go off with these words as we're coming back live, that the seed is nothing more than the harvest of sleep.
Yes, and I also want you to remember that destiny is not left up to chance,
but it is a matter of choice. Always choose Christ. God bless you. Peace.
Destiny is not left up to chance, but it is just a matter of choice.
What's the difference between the Maasar and the Terumah?
Yeah, so the Maasar is the tenth. It's specifically the tenth part. But the Terumah is the first fruit offering. It's the first gift that we give to our supervising priest. And here is our dad, you know, our father, the master prophet. So the Terumah is the first fruit, dad, while the Maasar or the tithe is the tenth. Totally different things. And you know, they don't even belong in the same basket.
They don't belong in the same baskets, but yet most churches, or not churches, but the people stick them in the same basket.
Yes.
And it violates the purpose of what they were intended for.
Mm-hmm.
We like to look at the tithe, the Maasar, is the tenth. That goes to the house of God.
Yes.
The building of ministry, the house of the Lord, the building of the temple. But then where does the Terumah go, Prophet John?
Wow, you know, that's such a great question, Dad, because, you know, the scriptures say it. It's interesting that right after it says, you've robbed me in the Maasar and the Terumah, it says to bring all of the Maasar into the storehouse, bring all of the tithes into the storehouse. And so we've been conflating that, you know, okay, we're bringing the tithes, we're bringing the offerings into the storehouse, but no, that's not what God says. We bring the tithe into the storehouse, and it's our Terumah that goes to the mouth of God, which is our supervising priest, the master prophet.
Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse.
Yes.
That's where they stored the grain in the temple. They took care of how things were to be taking place in the temple. And all of this stuff was supposed to be taken care of in the temple.
In the temple.
But then if we begin to look at that, that means something is gonna go without. Something is going to go denied. We bring the tithe to the storehouse,
mm-hmm.
and I have been guilty of doing a lot of stuff and taking care of the grain for the storehouse, doing stuff for the storehouse. But then I neglected the Terumah that goes to the priest. The first of all the first fruit, according to Ezekiel 44:30, goes to the priest. Stay connected. We'll talk more about this. See if you're violating. And if you are, you can correct it today. Make sure that you know that the tithe goes to the house of God, but the Terumah go to the mouth of God. And have you been serving the mouth of God?
God bless you. This is the choir master, and you're watching The Power of Prophecy.
Who you FaceTime?
FaceTiming. You FaceTiming Jesus. You on the FaceTime with Jesus. What y'all doing?
Seed in the ground. You're not seed in the ground.
Oh, you get your seed in the ground.
There's seed in the ground.
Wow.
Now, wait a minute. You can get your seed into the ground right from your phone?
Yeah, you can.
Wait a minute. Now,
text to give.
Text to give?
Text to give, yeah. Never heard of it? You never heard of it?
Wait a minute. Y'all look.
Text to give.
How do we do it? Come on, because there's some that have their phones out now, too, and they want to worship. How can we worship?
Just go onto your mobile phone, type in 646-762-0433. And
All right.
Type my worship, and easy like that.
And there's a QR. You know, when you hold your phone up there?
QR code as well. Hold it up, scan it.
A QR code.
You just got to put your phone right there on the camera, and then you just... type it right there, and it takes you.
You don't do the website.
You don't do the website,
Zoe, because you can do that on your phone. No. Okay, go, pull it up on your phone. You go to
ZoeMinistries.com.
Okay, and click on that nice little blue donate button we just put in.
Or you can go to BishopJordan.com.
Yes.
And you can always click on the link there.
Or maybe they want to call it in.
Now you can call it in as well. We can call it in.
Moderators are standing by right now. Call in your seed.
Yes, and you can call it in at 888-831-0434.
Or the lifeline number. Now, we grew up on that lifeline
number. Yes, we did.
That lifeline number is older than you are.
Stop telling your age.
Okay, I'm sorry. 212-316-2177. Again, that's 212-316-2177. It's called with some expectation because God loves a cheerful giver.
Indeed.
And our seed is always going before us.
God bless you.
And remember that destiny is not left up to chance, but it's a matter of choice.
Destiny is not left up to chance. It's a matter of choice.
The Spirit's telling me to say something. Point at the prophet and point at his mouth. And let me hear you say, there is money in the mouth of the prophet.
There is success in the mouth of the prophet.
There is prosperity in the mouth of the prophet.
There is deliverance in the mouth of the prophet.
There is salvation in the mouth of the prophet.
There is problem solving in the mouth of the prophet.
And what the prophet does is to believe God. Also in the Bible, the prophets are called seers. S-E-E-R. Because the prophet sees things and speaks things and speaks them into existence. Now, there are two things here. There is consistence and existence. The prophet sees all of the good that consists in God and speaks it into existence for you.
Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord, bless the Lord. Well, we thank God for all of you. And I'm not sure which is the red light. The red light stopped working.
We see green. No, that light is not on.
So we're looking at that camera there. The red light stopped working.
And that is blinking.
That is a that's a Mercury retrograde effect. Mercury is still in retrograde. Oh, the red light for that one is working. Does the red light on the other camera work too?
Red.
Oh.
They were working before.
Let me see. Let's go to this other camera here that you had me on. Okay. Yeah, the red light don't come on there. You see that? Over. See, that's so. We found the We found a Roman Mercury effect. That's right. Little Padawan Noah, but maybe it did something wrong. He looked at all this stuff and noticed that he went through his Felix the Cat bag and said, I got all the right switches on. I am not slow. And so he's gonna learn how to open up the bird camera. What's that bird camera called, Prophet Ernesto?
Bird dog.
He's going to learn how to open up the bird dog head and find out why the bird dog light is not on. You know, there's a lot of people walking around without the light on.
Mm. Oh, really?
Yeah. But Noah is going to find out what's going on with the bird dog today. It's going to be his first time doing bird dog surgery. So Noah's going to be trying to figure it out. Is that right, Noah? Yes, he sounds so excited about it. It's like a new game.
I have all the faith in Noah.
Yeah.
Get it all situated.
You have all the faith? Okay. I wouldn't, but no. That's your learning journey. We got to let him drive your car.
Amen.
Your car?
You said your car. You said you have all the faith.
Your car.
You said you have all the faith. I told you. You always knew where my faith stood.
Because he's a part of the community. He's a part of the team.
He is a part of the community.
So as a community, we will support him by letting him.
I'm supporting him. That's why they have passenger seats. That's why they have passenger seats. I'm supporting the community as the passenger. You got to have the right people in the right seat.
This is true.
All right.
You know, Your Grace, we have been having such a powerful time while you were trying to get back here. I know you spoke this morning in Brooklyn, and the Holy Spirit began to let us know that we needed to begin to stir up the ground and began to sow a $100 seed for an open heaven seed. And many individuals have already started doing that and have done that. We asked for 33, and I believe right now, we might be over 50. And if you allow me, I just want to give these other six individuals a quick
word. Oh, most definitely. Go right ahead.
We know we had Carol Williams.
Yes.
I just hear God said he's renewing your strength in this season. Take hope and know that all is not lost. Tasha Howard, I just hear God say, I see two things in your hand. I see purpose and I see wisdom. God said he's going to show you how to use them and utilize them for his glory. Tyrone Bracken, I just hear God said, do not become disheartened, but take courage in this season. Vanity Dennis, God said he's turning things around for you, even concerning your education. I don't know, I just see there's money that's there that has your name on it. Leonora McGinnis, I just hear God said, peace and favor shall be in your household in this season. Kelly Sayon, I just hear God said, push and move forward, move in faith in this season. Millicent Raglett, I just hear God said, new opportunities are showing up on the left side and the right side. You're going to be in the driver's seat. And Robert Goodman, he's number 50. I just hear God said, Robert, God said, get ready. Your voice is going to be heard because there's a new wisdom that's showing up in the name of the Lord. And those are the individuals. I believe I have all of them right now.
No, I've noticed something here. There's 239s. It's just a Mercury effect.
No, that's just those people that probably have given something and then they add something else.
Sure, because I see two people that's 39. I see a Carol Williams and a Naomi Cook. They gave both of them the number 39.
Yeah, because with me, you'll see 1,300 and something dollars. So those are several seats that have been combined.
Okay, I'm not sure.
And Naomi has already done her $100. Arlene Levis did a $100. So they probably gave previously, and they gave another seed.
So they would give them the same number as another person's number? So I'm just saying in the lineup list.
Yeah, I can go
back. So I'm just wondering if you might have thought you did, you might have done 39, but if you did 39, then one of them didn't get a word.
See, Arlene Levis, see, this is 100 plus 222.
No, I got that. But here on number 39, what I'm saying here is got after Renea Washington, Carol Williams, 39. And then it came back over here and they took 39 and they'll put Naomi Cook for $100, 39. So you have 239.
To the number 39. Maybe they miscounted.
So maybe it wouldn't be a miscount. It would be the person counted.
The moderator's acknowledging it. Yeah.
But if you called out a number five, you say, I already did number five, and you would have went over it, and then you'd be the 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Yes.
But that's a way to end up missing someone.
Yes.
So right. Either Carol Williams or Naomi Cook got missed. That's just an observation that I'm making over
yes,
here.
Yes, and that's why we went back to Carol Williams. Remember they said you did miss her.
Okay, so you did Carol Williams
right,
already.
Right, so when I came back, she was the first one that I spoke
to. Okay, great. So
they told me in the window.
That's what they've done. Okay, thank you so much. Okay, so we're going to, today's the first day of Rosh Hashanah.
Wow.
What's the year?
5783, I believe.
783.
And I want everyone to type in right now, there is money in the mouth of the prophet.
There is money in the mouth of the prophet.
Hmm. Begin to type that in. There is money in the mouth of the prophet. And the reason why I'm saying that, we're going to get ready to go into some things that I'm teaching here momentarily. But how you doing, Prophet Alexander Gray? How's everything coming along with you?
Master Prophet, Dr. Ibanah Jordan, great and great. Just blessing God for life, blessing God for health, and opportunity to move forward.
Amen. We bless the Lord for that. Amen. And we are beginning to do some things. Elder Bratt will be coming up shortly. He's in the process of getting some other equipment as we're trying something new with the set. And this is great. They're going to be checking the fuse and the bird dog in a moment. Amen. Let's see if we're going to see if they get that red light on when it works. Every so often, you know, the Mercury retrograde, this is why you don't buy a car right now unless you want to buy a lemon. Oh, no, you went and bought one last week. That's what happens when you don't have a prophet in your life that's continually speaking. Oh, no, you just purchased a lemon. Well, I tell you what, you probably didn't want that for a long time anyway, so you'll be trading it in. It would just be from lemon to somehow you'll be able to make some lemonade out of it. But, you know, this is not a good time to buy appliances and stuff. I wouldn't even encourage a person to buy a computer. As bad as you may need one, I would just suffer it through until after the second. Yeah.
Wait, a new iPhone just came out. I can't buy the iPhone during this season?
You can if you want it to have a lot of bugs in it. It's going to be a retrograde iPhone. You're going to have to take it back to the store. You're going to make many visits back to the store that you got it from. So, you got the new iPhone?
I didn't get that yet.
Sure, I don't know. I see two phones over there.
Yeah, it's two phones. Yeah, it's the Android.
When did you pick up that? That looked mighty new to me.
I was going to get it, but I said I'm going to wait because I know it's Mercury's in retrograde. So I learned before when that happened, my car went out on me. My engine blew out on me.
Oh, so wow. Tell us about what you purchased.
Remember I had the BMW?
Yeah.
I had the BMW, and the day that Mercury was retrograde, I was driving, and it stopped right there. And that's when the engine just...
Mm. We've had a lot of situations. We had our water cut off during Mercury retrograde. Yeah. We've had our electricity that had to be cut off. We got an oil spill that happened. They had to bring environment protection. That's happened. What's some other Mercury retrograde situations we've had?
Wow.
Honey, you can think of any others?
I can't think of any.
We also had, appliances would just stop, not work right. Mm-hmm. But it's not a bad thing. It just shows you what's not constructed in order and what you may have to, just take in reverse.
Amen.
They wanted to get into my mouth and do my teeth during it. I says, no. with the retrograde, and there's people that have had it. Now, I know someone that had to have a tooth situation done, but it really was a good one because it was a root canal. They had to do something else. But like I did, like I would do a root canal in a retrograde because you'd have to go in and do a two-part procedure and you want them to go back. Okay. Or if you did like a tooth extraction and you know that they had to put bone marrow, you got to go back to get it checked. So there's some good retrograde stuff too that you want to do in retrograde. You know, like I may want to collect your rent during retrograde because I want to keep coming back for the rent. Mm. Right? You know, there are some things you want retro, like breathing. Okay. Right? Don't you want to keep breathing?
Amen.
That's retro, right?
Definitely.
And all of the stuff that creates circulation. So retrograde is not a bad thing, it's just a great thing. Okay, so this is what we're gonna do. We're asking everyone to do, Prophet Deborah has taken on that challenge to ask everyone to do the $100 seed. And we can see we are out of rubella. And now we are on the way back. You know, we should find a way that when we get kicked out of rubella to be standing right outside the door. And like go right back, you know, like you almost like have two computers where we can switch it right from one to the other. Yeah. You know, and like it has a kill switch on the other. Mm. And see, can we say, okay, we're gonna kill you out of rubella because the next one's coming into rubella. So we can almost time it because it almost happens like as clockwork. And see if we can create a maybe design a relay switch called, you know, for corporations. So when it's getting ready to go out of bed, you have it and get the patent on that relay switch. And, you know, maybe they'll buy it from us. And it can call retro.
It's called it Mercury.
We'll call it retro. It's going to be called retro relay, right? Mm. Because it just keeps kicking you out. So we're back in rubella. Do we have any other unseats that we need to do, Prophet Deborah, before I get on into the teaching? I'm going to be also reading out the Terumah. We want you to get your Terumah seed in. We want to thank those of you for your generosity. This week has been a great week for many in the stock market, although the stock market was going down. And bears were out frolicking and playing while the bulls were sitting on the sideline within a praying mantis.
Wow. You know, Your Grace, that was so powerful. And this whole week, in observation mode and even participating, what you showed us and the scripture became so real to me. Lord, teach me to number my days and to apply myself unto wisdom. You demonstrated how to apply yourself to wisdom as you are numbering your days and stuff.
Mm-hmm. Now, let me just check in on those that are on the sites with us and maybe they can bring some of this up on the screen. We'll see if Noah can do that. The comments. Tell us if you had a Mercury retrograde situation happening in your life. Tell us what happened. It could be a fender bender. That's a real retrograde situation. Or it could be whatever you're naming it. Mm. Go ahead. Give it to us. What is your retrograde experience? I'm waiting for you to respond. Did you have a retrograde experience at all this in the last almost 21 days?
Oh, absolutely. Even something as simple as my time just being off. The traffic getting from point A to point B has been horrendous.
Yes. Yes.
On days
that
it's normally a breeze to get from point A to point B. Mm-mm. Now, something that had to take me 30 minutes to get to will take me 90 minutes.
Yeah, you know.
If not longer.
If not longer. So.
Yes.
That's true.
That's retrograde. And that's why it's a lot of times when Mercury's retrograde, tell people not to travel.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you can afford, if you can travel outside of that retrograde period. Okay. Sense. Anyone else can think of any retrograde? Did you have any retrograde experiences, Prophet Alexander?
Yes, Master Prophet. I had quite a few retrograde experiences. Financially, some funds was held up, and
you know, that's really retro too, isn't it? I mean, that's really that can be a real retro. But I had some funds held up too.
Yeah,
I had to get active in a retro. It was so bad until I was like, I says, okay, wait a minute, let me breathe. I said, I'm taking on another kind of personality. I says, I can't let this get to me like that. But I got you.
Another one, Master Prophet, we was going for a house, and that was a bad retrograde right there. And so it was, you know, when you're preparing and you gathering all your stuff ready to move, and then there's something that stops it, you know, that's, and then things that settle for you on the other side, that was a real bad retrograde right there. Mm-hmm. You know, like you said, don't do things when Mercury's retrograde. And I forgot Mercury's retrograde, and I was going through with the person to do the deal for the house.
That, and the thing that fell wow. through may have been the gift. See, that's what I want you to get. It's the gift. You don't see it as the gift until after you. So I had a person, they got upset with me with a word I gave them. I says, don't get this particular house. They said, Bishop, we're already set together. I said, there's something, I said, on the left side of the house, there's a crack in the foundation. This is the inspector and engineer said everything is fine. I said, oh, okay, go get it. They went and got it. A couple of months later, I owe you a seed, an apology. I said, what happened? The house is now swaying. They just found it was a crack in the left side, just like you said, in the foundation.
Wow.
Wow.
Of the house.
One day some people will listen to the prophet.
Well, you know, I think that you should listen. Reverend Run was told not to travel.
Travel
on
light.
This particular day. I said, don't, travel's not good for you on this day. So the rest of the team happened to go out the day before. He said, I'm gonna go and it's gonna be fine. He had a show in St. Louis, I believe it was St. Louis. He calls me from the airport. He says, Bishop, they changed planes. Everything was set to go. I know you told me not to travel on this day, but you never guess what happened. I said, what? Said everybody from Run DMC is there on the stage. I said, what's the problem? He says, a snowstorm just blew in, mm-hmm. and they can't get me there until tomorrow. I got to return and come home. We have to cancel. I said, he says, I know, but I, he said, you know what, that's the power of prophecy. And went home. I mean, what can you do?
You told him.
You know, but you know, when it looks, sometimes it doesn't look like the thing that has been prophesied. Mm. And so we got some retrograde stuff that has been shared here. Let me say, Naomi Cook said, 2 bathrooms flooded my office.
Wow.
Thank you for being transparent. And also she says, appliances going out. Good. Ina Crawley, I am waiting for information concerning a personal matter that I should have received weeks ago. Now, I might as well wait until October. You'll get it in October. Listen, it is. If I got any diagnosis right now during this period, I would go for a second diagnosis in October.
Mm. That's what I'm doing. You know, I took that special test, and I decided I'd talk to my doctor. So, you know what? I'm going to retake that test.
And oh, so yeah.
For November.
Oh, so, yeah, because yours came through in a retrograde period.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, it's the, let's see, insurance gets looped for no reason. You're fine, you're fine. 2 bathroom flood, yes, great. We got some of the people that is coming up. And Pat, you got anything that you needed to read there if you see any?
No, that's it, you did it.
Good. And so I can see that you don't want to talk about your retrograde experience. So we got it that y'all are all Mr. and Mrs. Retro Proof. We'll see.
Retro proof.
For those that didn't respond, give them a retro experience so that they can understand what this teaching is like. Okay? Elder Bellino, watch is not working.
Yeah, exactly. I get it.
You get it? Okay, we're going to find Elder Valina's going to be coming up to the stage in a moment.
Yeah.
We'll get her retro experience. Okay, we have a couple of individuals, but this is what I'm asking you to do. We are in the Jewish New Year.
Yes.
And did you find out what year it is?
No, it wasn't coming up.
Is it 5783?
See what year is
check. What? Someone tell us, what is the new year? And that is pregnant with a lot of meaning.
Yes.
Thank you. Duchess is offering this. I don't need no more retrograde. Duchess says...
5783.
Duchess says, my cell phone started having glitches yesterday. I know. And do not go and get you another one until after October 7th. Unless you want a glitchy one.
Master Prophet?
Yes.
It's 5,783.
Yes. And that is what's been said. Let's clap for the new year. Let's blow the shofar so Zoe can be acknowledging Rosh Hashanah, the Feast of Trumpets. The shofar. So with this, we're going to see that this is going to be a year of a lot of changes. We'll talk about that. Let me give you a couple of the prophetic warnings. I'm going to get into this word real quick. Is that get your vitamin D3 shots, pills, whatever you're doing. Get back on your protocol in a hurry. The final wave of COVID is not knocking at the door. It's in your house. Okay? Wow. So you want to build up your immune system now. And what should your D3 be according to what some of our health professionals said to us that are into preventive care, not the ones that are into sick? So they got two different numbers here. There's a group of doctors that need you sick. That's the only way they get paid. I don't know why they call it health care insurance. It should be called sick care. So, thank you. Dr. Dominisha Hurley is on it, 80 to 100. Let's give that a hand, Dr. Dominisha Hurley. Got it. And it's the vitamin D3. Just don't pick up any vitamin D, and you come jacked up, and your eyes just blink nonstop. No. Get D3. Get on your vitamin C. We've also starting our protocols with the ginger. Prophet Deborah, tell them how we're going to do ginger. And we probably should get someone to go in the studio and do the Mother Jordan ginger song. Mother Jordan used to sing it. She says she knew she was being COVID-free. She was like, ginger in the morning, ginger in the evening, ginger all day long. She was ginger, ginger, ginger. We had ginger in everything. We had ginger in her drinking water. She was tasting ginger in her tea. She always had like ginger in her coffee, ginger in her food, ginger in her orange juice. We just had her. We had her ginger. You know, she almost probably thought her name was Ginger. Mm. Okay, Prophet Deborah, give the protocol. And listen, and we definitely want you on this protocol because last time you got COVID, you was out for a month. Ernesto.
So what are the ways to give, Pastor?
No, we didn't say give. We said get the ginger. It was so bad that we didn't understand. Says Stephen was saying, wait, I thought Ernesto has COVID. He's outside playing with his children in the snow. I think, Danny, you remember that, right?
Mm. Oh, now we all remember. Okay.
And then it says, wait, your 10 days is up. My wife sneezed. I think she may have ginger. I don't want to come back. We waited for her test. You calling that? Did she get the test yet? No. Something with the car. We're going to get her test tomorrow. Well, you think she should be back? I don't think she. No. I just don't want to contaminate anyway. And then after that, okay, one of the children got COVID now. Okay, Ernesto, I was around Raphael yesterday. He hugged me. I need to quarantine for another 10 days. He was out 30 days.
30 days.
Give him a hand for his 30-day leave.
Thank you. Thank you, media team. Thank you for...
So we're going to... Pastor's going to be giving out the recipe. And, Pastor, we got to make sure that Z have the recipe.
Yes.
Because it's a community that we have at the house. So I couldn't just come out and then impact the entire community.
Yeah, but you affect the whole neighborhood by playing outside.
No, because I do remember during that time, a great mentor of mine said that it's good to get fresh air into the lungs.
Yeah, but...
Because that's what he did.
But, thank you. You follow the shepherd.
The shepherd was not out 30 days. He's digging a deeper hole. Okay, this is an example of retrograde saints. Listen, and he's Gemini as well, which is ruled by Mercury, so it's like a double. Okay.
It's a quadruple Mercury.
Okay, so tell them, Prophet Deborah, how the people of God can get the ginger made.
Yes, Your Grace. What we do at the EOR is we get fresh ginger. And I like to wash it off really well, and I slice it very thin, very fine. Some people grate it. I don't like all the little stringiness. I slice, and then you put in a big pot of water with ginger sticks. Some people use the cinnamon powder, but you want the ginger sticks. I think, to me, that's much smoother. And just let it boil. I let it come to a boil, and then I cover it and let it just simmer in there. And then after, you could drink it hot. I like it hot, or some people drink it like almost like an iced tea. Also, when you're doing, if you're going to use the cinnamon powder, there's two types of cinnamon powder. You want the Ceylon, C-E-Y-L-O-N. That's the better.
Say it again so we can have a prophet type this in. Which one you want?
I'll type in it also. The C-E-Y-L-O-N, the Ceylon, that's the better cinnamon if you're going to use cinnamon powder, which I didn't realize there's two types of ginger, cinnamon. Wow. And the cinnamon, you can use the Ceylon, or you could use, or you can use the other cinnamon, but this one is the better cinnamon, and it goes into your body and your system much better than the other one. But it's just the water, fresh ginger, again, and cinnamon. Again, I prefer the cinnamon stick. And then if you want to put some cinnamon powder in it, you can, but I prefer the cinnamon stick. And let that just seep and simmer. And then what I do sometimes, I may squeeze some lemon juice in mine as well, just to have a little twist.
That's good.
And if you want something, and because cinnamon is naturally sweet, so it does give you a little sweetness, but some of you might want a little sweetener. Just put a little bit of honey in it. I don't, but if you so choose, you can. Or monk fruit.
All right. Okay, let's give Prophet Deborah a hand. What you thought about that, Prophet Stephen? Because I know you are the chef in your house, and is that kind of like the way you was making yours?
I'm sure
you added a little something else to yours. Come on. That's
in the colder months.
And what would that be? Because that's like it's starting to get cold now.
Well, it's a special thing that keeps you warm and drive out phlegm.
Oh, my goodness. Well, what is it? Legs are smiling. Legs is looking here. Does it come from Puerto Rico?
It can.
Okay. So stay tuned. By the end of the telecast, he'll give you that special thing. He has to figure out how to spell it.
Dr. Dominisa Hurley said brandy.
Oh, Prophet.
Is that what Dr. Dominisa Hurley said? Dr. Dominisa Hurley, that's what you use?
She says she typed in brandy.
Is it a question or she's saying? No, she's telling us she uses.
No, you tell us. Is this like the Price is Right type of answer deal? Let's make.
I'm pretty sure it makes it do right.
It makes it do right? All right. So this is to help to keep your body from being filled with mucus. If you know you eat ice cream every day like Elder Valina, you may want to do like every other day you cut back. If you know you put cheese on your cheese sandwiches or burgers like Noah every day, you may want to take the cheese off your burger until springtime. Okay? You may lessen the pizza. Mm-hmm. With the cheese, like extra cheese, you might just do a little cheese. You know, you want to keep mucus, create a mucus-free body. That helps out, don't it?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah, because when COVID comes, it like is when mines came, I was only able to breathe out of one nostril. And then all of a sudden, both nostrils, no air was coming out. I was going to be like this and say, and it gets worse at night. COVID at night is where the demons come up. Mm-hmm. I could hear them saying, I'm going to kill you in your bed and nobody's here because you're in isolation. And you can't breathe.
That cough is wicked.
I had to, the little breathing tube. We're going to have to get those machines out to start doing clearing, because it takes COVID about 3 days to get from your nasal down to the lungs, I believe they say. There was some night I had that on my face, like oxygen, like it was a breathing machine. I said, wait a minute, this is the vaporizer. I was, the nebulizer. I was like getting a little air. I was like, but it would only happen, it would only get that severe at night. I learned how to sleep in the bed sitting up.
Mm. Wow.
Wow.
Yeah. I hope. Oh, wait, rosin. Oh, wait a minute. They're all telling us a little bit what they're putting in ginger. Hold on.
Yeah.
Hold on. If you are in the chat room.
Rosin reams.
Oh, my goodness. They are telling. Get this up on the screen.
Wow.
Come on, Noah. Get this stuff on.
PR.
Get it up here on the screen. They are giving y'all recipes. Okay, Prophet Naomi said using the diffuser eucalyptus with thieves oil is good. Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Somebody said black pepper. Now, would you put the black pepper in the diffuser? I don't think so. No.
Or the tea.
Oh, in the
ginger.
In the ginger. Okay. Someone said, Roslyn says, bourbon and branch?
Bourbon and branch?
I don't know. What's branch?
Bourbon and branch.
You know,
well, I don't know.
Duchess says...
Never hurt nobody.
Duchess says...
Rum.
She says rum, PR.
That's
Puerto Rican rum.
There you go.
Is that like a cough syrup?
No, it's called Bacardi. It can be.
What does it do?
Give you a good night's
sleep. Warm up that chest.
It cleans out the mucus.
Okay. Clean up that mucus.
It warms up that chest.
You drink it and you can rub it on.
So that's what you do in the winter?
Not necessarily, we give you different remedies.
No, we were asking Dr.
Steve, come on.
What's your remedy?
Tell us your secret.
Tell us your secret, the stuff that put the hair on your chest.
Let's wait till as it get colder, you know. Because why share it now? You're not ready for it yet. Wait till winter come. Mother Winter hasn't showed up yet.
Legs has something he want to say. Let's go to Legs over here. Legs, you come right on the set here. Here. Come sit down here, Legs. You can come right down.
Right.
Come on down here. Let me see. Obed got you a new toy. Hey, man, we made room for you here. You test it out. Come on over here, Obed. Sit next to them. They got our set. They got us a whole new set going on here. This is so nice. This is the power of prophecy. This is the power of prophecy new look for Rosh Hashanah. Yeah. Okay, what do you want to say, Legs?
I said, I bet Obed could bring us something to put in the tea.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. You would have to use it after the show is over.
You'd use it after the show?
it would clear you up.
It would clear you up? It'd probably be a different kind of show, too.
Yes.
Definitely. Yeah.
But, Dr. Hurley says, cognac brandy will knock out that mucus, cover up, and sweat it out. All right, sweat it out.
Yeah.
So that's what you do.
Cognac.
Have you heard of cognac, Legs?
Yeah. Absolutely, Bishop.
I've never.
Does it work?
What does it look like? Is it white, yellow, green, red?
There's a couple. There's a couple of different ones.
There's a couple of different ones?
Yeah.
Depends on the aggression rate.
Yeah, Cavassier guy myself. But there's some different brands out there.
Kyle Lovick said cognac will also knock you out.
Mm-hmm.
Cognac will knock you out?
That's what they're saying. Kyle is saying.
Look at Prophet Rosin Reams put here.
Prophet Rosin Reams put?
Give me some bourbon and branch equal bourbon whiskey with plain water. Very old school Very old school, Southern.
Southern old school.
Oh, okay. And Sandrika Gilchrist, she switch brandy or cognac? So she wants to know which one.
Yes, Stephen.
All right, the answer in the chat room, okay. Now, they're not saying nothing at all.
And all of those make a great
sweet tea. They're not saying nothing in verbella. They're sweetly saved in verbella.
Yes. You can make a nice sweet tea with it till you freeze your peaches and use those as ice cubes.
Okay, so you can freeze...
Sweet tea, yeah, you can just freeze the peaches, the sliced peaches, and use those as ice cubes. With your cognac or your whatever.
With your cognac. Freeze your peaches. Now, but cognac don't have
No. The peaches.
You freeze the peaches.
Is it fresh
they
peaches?
Become your ice cubes in your sweet tea.
In your sweet.
Oh, that's nice.
So how y'all?
I think so.
So then I'm confused with where the cognac comes in it.
You can pour that in there too, to give it a little strumpf.
Okay.
A little strumpf.
Oh, with the ginger.
Let it marry.
Okay, Prophet Naomi, my daughter says that sounds like moonshine. What is moonshine?
That is a specialty. It can be made about it just about anything. You can make it out of potatoes, you can make it out of corn.
All right.
But here's the thing. If you don't want the drink to be weakened, don't use ice cubes. Freeze your peaches and put it in there. That's all I'm saying.
Oh, okay. I don't know.
He's
trying to tell you freeze your peaches because apple may not have as much water as peaches do. You know, the juice in the peaches could need to freeze up.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So that was cold. So what he's trying to say, you don't want to put an ice cube in your drink because it weakens
it.
He says, but if you do a frozen peach in it that's sliced up and freeze up. It won't weaken it. You'll have full strength.
Yeah, because you need it at night. Because you want a good sleep. And if you don't want to take like a NyQuil, you make your own.
So just
because you want to sleep. Because I've had that. It felt like that cough, like your whole chest is coming. It's a painful cough at night. And so if you induced into a great sleep, you're good.
So it makes you sleepy.
Okay. I agree with Prophet is Rosalind. Prophet Stephen is a total mixologist.
Okay, yeah, Prophet Rosalind said that she calling you the mixologist.
He's dropping signs.
Mixologist.
We're going to find out what you were in your other life. One day we're going to go, we want to do your documentary.
It starts in Puerto Rico.
All right. Deanna says moonshine is just unnamed whiskey made at night. Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Under the moon.
Okay, so this is good. So, thank you. Thank you for this. So we're trusting the Lord for all y'all to do some great things in this season. Okay, Prophet Deborah, we're gonna let's unseat some prophets. Let's do it this way. Give me the unseat. Okay, did we do some breaking news?
No, we was waiting for you.
Waiting for me? Okay. Well, y'all got it there quick. okay, Professor, we're gonna go ahead and do the breaking news here. So we have some breaking news. Prophet Joshua is not here today. He is just a little in the weather. He's not under the weather. He is in the weather. He's in the weather.
He's in the eye of it.
He's right there dancing in the weather. Okay, we have breaking news. We have Prophets Willie Mae Barnes who have done a $1,000 seed. Let's hit it. Man. Okay, let's hit it for Prophets Willie Mae Barnes.
Ask the prophet, we have some breaking news.
I'm glad I have a good heart.
Not shy yet.
Get up. Master prophet. Get up. Master prophet. Get up. Get jiggy with it. Get
You can take it to the left, to the left, then to the right, to the right, to the left, to the left, then to the right, to the right, to the left, to the left, to the right, to the right.
We got another breaking news. I got to call him, see if he's going to meet me in Chicago this weekend. Douglas Miller did a $1,000 seed.
Amen.
Let's hit it, DJ. Hit it.
Pass the prophet. You have to break it.
We got another breaking news. Prophetess Deborah Jordan did $1,365.26. Let's hit it. Let's hit it, DJ. Hit it.
Pass the prophet. We have some breaking news.
I'm glad I have a good heart.
Shia.
Get up. Get up. Get up. What?
Get jiggy with it, to the left, to the left, then to the right, to the right, to the left, to the left, then to the right, to the right, to the left, to the left, to the right, to the right.
We're back. We got another breaking news. Uh-oh, can you... A leading temple seer.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see that?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Who is it, Prophetess Deborah?
Prophetess Willie Mae Barnes.
No, no, no.
Temple seer. Prophet... Nichelle Berrien
sold
the $1,242.22 seed, Master Prophet. Just thought you should know.
All right, let's hit it, DJ. Hit it.
Master Prophet, we have some breaking news.
I'm glad I have a good heart.
Shia.
Get up. Get up.
Jiggy with it, to the left, to the left, then to the right, to the right, to the left, to the left, then to the right, to the right, to the left, to the left, to the right, to the right.
like crack.
All right. Well, we give God praise. We give God praise. We want to thank all of you for your seed and your giving. We ask for an open heaven seed. And today you probably noticed a very strange text. We asked for you to do $223 seed for the new year. But this is just like God. Let the Jewish New Year be the eve of the new year. The evening and the morning starts the first day. Mm-hmm. And so this begins our agricultural new year, which means we are in season of harvest. On Friday, I had to give a $10,000 seed because of what the Lord had created. In that day, Legs did a breaking news seed of $1,000, and there was several people did $1,000. I'm Prophet Rosalind, and the bears are out playing in the market. Every time the market was going down, it did something. But I keep seeing a 1,000 point drop in a day.
Ooh,
I see 1,000 to 2,000 points.
Wow.
I see that in a day. Now, I wish I knew the exact date. I don't have the exact date, but I know it is upon us. I know we're in a bear season. Legs made a call. He said he saw the S&P going to 3,000. It is right now at, I don't know what it says, it's 36 something. Now, it hasn't quite hit my number yet, which was 360.
Okay. Working.
But it is, what, almost minutes away from that? It may be tomorrow. It may be tomorrow if it doesn't rally tomorrow. Because I got two numbers, I got 385 and 360s.
Okay.
Now, when it hits that 360, I'm going to be honest with you. I'm going to place calls because I believe that's the bottom of that period, 360, and I have to wait for another word. So I'm going to be, I believe it's going to be jumping back and forth between 360 and 385.
Okay.
I think that's the magic number. Now, Stephen, are you going to be playing with the Bears?
And Bulls? Yes, indeed.
Yeah. Now, and I'm waiting to hear yet another word. Mm-hmm. Now, will it go down below 360? Probably so. Mm-hmm. But some of us put on. Well, I put on for November 4th, 3,000 spine. Oh, I probably shouldn't have told any of you that. Mm. That this part is not a word.
Right.
This is a hunch.
Right. And there's a difference.
But it may not hit the 3,000 until the 31st of the year, or around about, I'm really feeling something like around the 23rd. Mm. But again, we will have the SEE. So we'll see what the Lord does this week. And there'll be a rally somewhere in here. Don't that feel good, Elder Valina?
It does.
You're getting a breeze.
It's like read me.
Well, the volume is
I read you, yeah.
Yes, it was like,
Was that read accurate?
Yes.
Okay, so maybe what we're saying right now is accurate, Legs. Have you been taking notes? You're gonna get your positions in? You know where you're going.
Well, the volume is high. This, you know.
The volume for what?
For December.
The December? So y'all know how to read that stuff.
See, the
for,
volumes, the de- yeah, yeah.
for the
There's
December 12:30?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, inananabosha.
Jesus.
Father, I promise I will worship you. If you, I will work. The Lord knows that I can be trusted.
Thank you, Lord. Yes. Thank you, Father.
I gave my teruma today to Bishop Lilia Baines. Mm-hmm. Because I needed some place to put my teruma, so to command the blessing. So I had to do a $2,500 teruma. I had to command the blessing there. And I've already got my tithe in, and now I'm ready to set for the next stage. The next stage is here.
Amen.
And I don't want you to miss it. Okay, let's get ready here, and we are looking for those that will do the $1,000 seed or the $2,223 seed. We're just calling it 2223, $223.23 seed. You've seen the text message. And let's go now to Hebrews chapter 11. We're going to do this word in about 8 minutes.
Wow.
But let's do this here. We got a couple of people to unseat. They're giving me some unseats. Let's see this. Which prophets are available?
Prophet Olympia Castillo.
Okay.
Good evening, Dr. Bernard Jordan.
God bless you. Prophets Olympia Castillo. I'm going to have you call Allison Goodman, Naomi Cook, and Arlene Leviste.
Thank you. Received.
Great.
Your prophet is... God bless you, Dr. Bernard Jordan. Prophetess Denise Bullock is available.
Okay, God bless you. You can call Kelly Say, Carla Mingo, and Nichelle Berrien.
Absolutely. God bless you.
All right. Okay, I believe that's it. I believe. Did I? No.
Prophetess Evelyn Lilly is available, Your Grace.
All right. Okay, Prophet Evelyn Lilly, I'm going to have you call Gladys Austin, Cynthia Scurry, Brooklyn. You can call them again. Let me go back to my other way. Okay, did we get somebody to call a Mingo? I tell you what, and do call a Mingo. Thank you.
Amen.
Yes. Yep. Master Prophet.
Okay, thank you. Okay, thank you, Prophet Bull. Okay. I'm kind of out of my protocol. I got a protocol. Okay. Okay, I think we got everyone. Okay, let's go to Hebrews chapter 11 and verse number 1. I want to talk for a moment about how you've been framed. Someone read for me Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1.
I will, Master Prophet. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen.
Okay, so let me just say this here. Now faith is. So we need to know what is now faith. Number one, there's no such thing as tomorrow faith. There's only now faith. Mm. Now faith is the what?
Substance of things hoped for.
Substance. The substance means a title deed. Prophet Kelly, if you're here, can you come to the stage?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Now faith is the substance. Notice, it is the substance. It's the title deed, the ground support. But sometimes we read over words so quickly that we miss messages.
That's the truth. Mm. That's the truth.
You see that? But it's the substance of what?
Things.
I want to stop at things for a moment. Because now faith is a substance of things. Mm-hmm. There's individuals that have said to me, it's not all about money, Bishop Jordan. Yes, it is, because if it's not about money, you're negating my faith.
Ah.
It's not about houses and cars. Well, if it's not about that, you're negating my faith. Because faith is the substance of what?
Things.
And where are the things?
Hoped for.
Which means my vision board. If there is no vision board, if there's no things in my vision board, faith cannot work.
Right. People perish without a vision.
Yes, yeah, say it again.
The people perish without a vision.
Yeah, without a vision, the people do perish. So watch this. If the people are perishing without a vision, then the question is, what does your faith look like in the absence of things? Mm. Then it's no faith. Mm. Where there are no things hoped for, there is no faith available. Mm. Faith can only work when things are in your